first Big 12 game. They take on the Kansas State Wildcats. So glad you have found us with my longtime partner, Devin Gardner. I am Eric Collins. This is an important game on many levels for UCF. This is their very first Big 12 conference game. Devin, they win today. They're a perfect 4-0. And they've got this quarterback, a backup quarterback that they really like in Timmy McClain.
Yeah, how about the luxury of having a guy that has started some college games already, right? He came over from USF, and now he finds himself with the second opportunity to take a start, and it's before the start of the UCF tenure in the Big 12. I'm really excited to see this guy play. He has a lot of the same skill set that John Rhys Plumlee has as far as his ability to run and throw and make plays inside and outside the pocket. So they don't have to change the offense a bunch, but he's going to have a real stiff test this week against the defending Big 12 champ, Kansas State Wildcats.
And no disrespect, but this is no longer Villanova. This is now a different type of cat. This is the Kansas State Wildcats. Let's talk about Kansas State. It's been a difficult week for them. Of course, that gut punch a week ago, they lost the nail biter against Missouri. And now this week at practice, it was up and down because their quarterback, Will Howard, in and out of the lineup. We don't know what we're going to see from him tonight.
Yeah, he was hobbled a bit a week ago, and we saw the young rookie get a chance, the young freshman, Avery Johnson. He got a chance in the game last week, and I think we're going to see both those guys this week. Now, the extent in which we're going to see Avery Johnson depends on Will Howard's health. Can he protect himself? Can he be the Will Howard of old that helps this Kansas State Wildcat team win the game? If he can't be that guy, Avery Johnson will be the guy. And I'm just telling you, Eric, you're going to see a guy who can run and throw with the best of them. Now, they're going to have to shrink the package just a bit so he can play free and play fast. But I'm just telling you, they're comfortable with both these guys.
Avery Johnson, 18 years of age. Good golly. Let's do it. Big 12 football under the lights. It's the conference lid lifter for both schools. It's UCF. It's Kansas State. Our kickoff coming your way in just a moment. How else would you start a football game in the Big 12? Rock, paper, scissors. Welcome to the Big 12. Knights of UCF, and it's going to be tough if you're already losing rock, paper, scissors. Congratulations, but that actually doesn't count for much. We're going to play some real football. Now let's take a look at the keys to the game, sponsored by Hampton by Hilton for the stay.
For UCF, you have to impose your will. You have to get in that run game. They average just under 300 yards a game rushing the ball. They have to continue to be that team and pick your spots. Allow Timmy McClain to be in the rush game, but also allow him to take his shots. And for Kansas State, you have to protect the ball. Make sure that you don't put the ball in harm's way, especially if you have the young guy in the game. And you got to stop the run. Stopping the run is so important, especially against a team that rushes for almost 300 yards a game.
Chris Klieman and Kansas State won the coin toss, and they said, we want the football. Why not? Can't score unless you have it. So Colton Boomer, one of the best kickers, if not the best kicker in the entire country, will get us started. Conference opener for both sides. Kansas State and UCF playing their first Big 12 game of the year. UCF, their first Big 12 game ever. And wow, that barely stayed in bounds. We were about to get all over Colton Boomer, but that one stayed in bounds and it'll be a true touchback. So here comes the offense for Kansas State. Kansas State 2-1 on the year. The only blemish was the loss a week ago against Missouri, and already good news for the home team. Will Howard is healthy enough to play.
Yeah, he's out there, and he's just a little ginger. You can see even in the jog. But we will see Avery Johnson at some point in this game. But it's a really good sign that Will Howard's able to jog out there and take these opening snaps.
Every opening drive this season for Kansas State has resulted in a touchdown. They start from the 25. Blitz is picked up. Throws a strike. That's his guy, Ben Sinnott, All-American tight end with a grab.
It's a nice job. No trickery there. Just got on the wheel route and makes a nice combat catch, a contested catch where a guy's hitting you at the same time. He does a very good job of that.
Carry up, first down, DJ Giddens. And Giddens moves forward across the 40. Let's take a look at the starters on the offensive line. Cooper Beebe, we're going to see him all over the line. That's been the case for the first three games. We expect to see Christian Duffy, number 73. They say he's healthy enough to at least play at some point today. DJ Giddens is going to get a bunch of carries. Trayshawn Ward, not expected to play. He is banged up. Sinnott lines up in the backfield as a fullback. Off the back foot, throw and catch. Beautiful. Jaden Jackson, a first down for K-State.
That is good stuff by Will Howard. We know that he's not as mobile as he usually is. He's got a guy right in his face slapping at the ball, and he drives that ball perfectly on Jackson's numbers.
Quick to the line. And that little look at me offense. Second carry for Giddens. If you're UCF, do you just kind of disregard the potential fake of that handoff, knowing that Howard probably didn't want to run?
I don't think you can 100%, just because even when he was hobbled a week ago, Howard did take off and run for a big first down. But this defensive front is a little bit banged up as well. Ricky Barber didn't play a week ago, but having him back is a big deal. DeJordan Mask in the secondary is also a guy that's back for UCF on defense.
Second down and 9 after the 1 yard run. Another chance for Giddens. He's got the first down and more. Look at Giddens go inside the 10. Brandon Adams saved a touchdown, but a massive rip by Giddens.
Look at Cooper Beebe get around and clear the way for Giddens to get through, and you make one guy miss, you get to that second level, it's going to be issues. Nice job by Giddens getting down the field.
I smelled that one. Gave him the stanky leg. 36 yards for Giddens. Down to the 8. Three receivers. Bottom of the formation. Interesting. First down and goal. Yeah, they do want to throw. Howard. Little fade. Looking for the sixth-year senior, Phillip Brooks, second down.
Yeah, they absolutely love to run that corner route when you get man-to-man down here, and he had him. He just overthrows it just a bit.
All right, K-State in the red zone. This is a point of emphasis. Colin Klein, the offensive coordinator, said last year wasn't so good. 44% red zone touchdown percentage. This year through three games, that's a big number, 86%. You'll take that. Ooh, one-handed catch of a bad snap, and look at Howard! Oh, they told us he was banged up, didn't look like it there.
I'm telling you, this is a tough guy, if I've ever seen one. He was banged up, and I'm talking about really hobbled in the game a week ago, but I saw him when it was an opportunity. He took that ball down when he had to run.
Caught that with one hand. The snap was close to his shoulder.
I wouldn't be surprised if they don't go Q power here. Let that big body just rumble and get a yard.
Where there's a will, there's a way. Giddens next to Howard. They put the tight end Swanson in motion. This is Giddens, and he walks into the end zone. That is the fourth consecutive game that Kansas State has taken the opening possession in for a touchdown.
Everybody's just man on man, man on man. Tight end's going to come across the kick and allow Giddens to just find his hole. This is his job. You find the hole. Where is it? Right there. And you power into the end zone. Nice job by Giddens.
For Giddens, that is his first rushing touchdown of the season.
So surprising, right? Such a talented runner to get down in the red zone, but he just hasn't found his way in the end zone as a rusher.
Extra point. Chris Tenitz tacks it on. And it's a 7-0 lead. Kansas State says to UCF, welcome to the Big 12. It's not going to be easy. Welcome back, everyone. FS1 College Football sponsored by Hampton, by Hilton, for the stay. And that's what a happy sellout crowd looks like. Manhattan, Kansas. Kansas State takes the opening drive. They march all the way down the field and put in a touchdown, DJ Giddens. They lead 7-0 before UCF has even touched the ball as a Big 12 team.
Looks like it's so far so good for Kansas State in their beginning of their title defense.
All right, back deep to receive the kickoff from Chris Tennant. That is Johnny Richardson. High and into the end zone, touchback. All right, so here comes the UCF Knights offensive line, the ones that are highlighted, playing new positions this week.
Yeah.
Marcellus Marshall moved from tackle to guard. Kittler is getting the start at the center. And Amari Kite had been the backup left tackle. He's playing right tackle today. And the skill position guy, Randy Pittman, he's a true freshman. He is going to get his first collegiate start at tight end.
Now, on the offensive line, Coach Malzone said they need to get more physically strong and bigger to go up against this daunted Kansas State defensive line. And here's your quarterback, Timmy McClain. He's going to get an opportunity today to get on the edge and make some plays with his arm and legs.
Lefty McClain keeps it. Gets to the edge and get, oh my goodness, got stoned. That's a bad idea. Kobe Savage and Jacob Parrish combined, but it's a gain of 13.
Yeah, and he gets on the edge right away, but this is what you have to avoid, right? They don't know exactly what they have in their backup quarterback risk right now. They cannot go three deep at the quarterback position. He has to protect himself on those running opportunities.
Carry, this is Richardson. Look at Johnny Richardson fly! Down inside the 20. Like a lightning bolt.
I mean, there's no get to the second level. The linebackers just overplay it, and the part's like the Red Sea, and Richardson is down the middle.
Man, he can scoop. Senior from Lake Wells, Florida, has it in the red zone. Two plays into this drive. Another gift to Richardson. Couple of yards.
For Richardson, he's small, right? So you don't get a chance to see him. On that long run, the linebackers couldn't see him, so they jumped outside assuming that the ball was going there, and he just split right down the middle.
All right, these are your starters defensively for K-State. We're talking about Austin Romaine because he is a true freshman. Mm-hmm. He's getting a start. Daniel Green, out for the year, tore his pec a week ago.
Yeah.
Still played through it at Missouri, but he's out for the year. Middle linebacker. Usually what makes the calls, a lot of decisions, all that kind of stuff. So we'll keep a close eye on Austin Romaine this evening.
It's a nice job by Khalid Duke, making sure that he sets the edge, he squeezes down, forces a pull, and then he jumps outside. He's one of the best athletes on this defense, and Timmy McClain has to recognize he may not always be able to get to the edge if 29 is the guy setting it.
There's a good look at Austin Romaine. True freshman, Hillsboro, Missouri.
Safety's gone. You got it down here.
They can get a first down at the 5. Quick hitter, low pass. Did it bounce? I think they said it was caught, but it's not going to be close enough for the first down. Xavier Townsend got it. I actually thought the ball bounced, but that's just me.
It did look like it bounced, but it's a tough decision because you match heads over there.
Oh, yes. It's going to be fourth down.
Look at that eye.
So they call it an incomplete pass. We see those little pebbles bounce up into the air. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's a bounce if I've ever seen one. But I don't like the decision by Timmy McClain because you have matched heads over there. And what I mean by matched heads is each defender is over a guy. So there's nobody to block the unblocked defender. You want to much rather go to the opposite side one-on-one so you can get a route down the field and allow your wide receiver to win versus that zero coverage.
Colton Boomer has never missed less than a 64-yard field goal. In his college career, now 2 years deep, he has only missed once. He missed a 64-yarder last year. Guy's a stud. Puts 3 points on the board. It's a 7-3 ball game in Manhattan. We have played close to 6 minutes here in our first quarter. It is a 7-3 lead. Both sides have scored the first time they touched it. A field goal for Gus Malzahn's team. 6 plays, 63 yards. The big play, the 48-yard run by Richardson. And Boomer continues to just be a weapon for UCF. He has missed one field goal in 22 tries now in his college career. 21 for 22.
Super impressive.
He's hit 11 in a row, dating to back last year. And now he'll kick it off. We'll sing his praises, and now he'll probably hit it out of bounds. That's not going out of bounds. But it's returnable. So here he comes. And out to the 32-yard line. That's Seth Porter. And there's a flag down.
Yeah, it's a plethora of flags. They're going to get a hold.
Michael Vanderveld is our referee.
The hole, I think, was so egregious, a piece of equipment came off.
During the return, holding number 39, receiving team, 10-yard penalty, it's first down.
Jordan Shippers, backup running back.
Yeah, right down here, you can see him. He got ran right through, right? You get those guys on kickoff running as fast as they can. It's pretty tough to absorb that hit, but he absorbs it and kind of takes him down with him. So he's going to back Kansas State up.
So second drive for Will Howard. He was really good first time they had him. Remember, we still expect to see Avery Johnson, 18-year-old quarterback, just as a change of pace, even though Howard healthy enough to get the start. Mm-hmm. Pitch and catch, DJ Giddens for a good gain on first down.
One thing you see with Will Howard, and I remember being a quarterback and having an injury, it really makes you focus and pay attention to detail that much more, right? So you have to have a plan. You can't be as nifty with your feet as you usually are to get out of danger, right? So you got to know exactly where you want to go with the ball, and that's what we're seeing here early in this game.
Giddens has it. Able to get the first down before he's actually touched. Offensive line doing their job. That's another first down for K-State.
I love to see him get behind Big Ben Sennett and kind of sift through and find his way as he picks up another Wildcat first down.
Already 50 yards for Giddens. Five carries, 50 yards. Brooks, the man in motion. Play action. Howard wants a bunch. He's got his tight. Out to midfield. Second catch for Ben Sennett.
It's a nice job. Ben Sennett getting wide here and then getting across the field. Just gets right behind those linebackers. And how about the tightness of that throw? That window is small, and Will Howard fits it right into the big target, Ben Sennett.
And Quadrick Bullard in on the tackle, still down on the ground. That's a gain of 22 for Sennett. Sennett had a great game a week ago, two touchdowns against Missouri. There was a drop or two, so he's playing with a little bit of an edge. He is an All-American type guy at the tight end spot.
I mean, whatever you want, right? The blocker, the guy at the point of attack, the decoy, the big guy, the lineup at wide receiver, as that wide receiving tight end, the inline tight end to run vertical against linebackers. I mean, he does it all for this team, and he's getting better and better at the blocking game as well.
From Waterloo, Iowa. First and 10, balls at the 49. Good times for the Wildcats. Giddens slips out of the first tackle. Walter Yates had him, got away, and Matthew Alexander finished him off. It's game of three. Quadrick Bullard had to leave the game. Jaira Wilson is now playing one of the safety spots, vacated by Bullard. Wilson's number 9 in white. Howard picked off! Terrible pass. Corey Thornton's got it, and it's a sudden change for UCF. That is what they needed. First mistake of the game.
You gotta love the technique from Thornton. You're not gonna see it until he comes in the screen here. He jumps right in front of this route to take it away. It's not a bad throw, but he just beats him to the spot. He's watched film, he's seen. They love to go to the RPO and run these slants out of this formation, and he jumps it.
Second interception in the first four games for Corey Thornton. And it's gonna be UCF with wonderful starting field position. They scored a field goal the first time they had it. So Timmy McClain working out of that gun. That is R.J. Harvey. First carry for R.J. Harvey. Came into this game leading UCF in carries with 39.
Gotta love Will Lee III coming from his cornerback position and being the enforcer and the kind of the edge protector in that style of defense.
The Plain only threw it once, first time they had the football. Little end around Xavier Townsend. Going to bring up third down and short. Will Lee coming in from his corner spot to make the tackle. Gain of 8, third and 2. Trent Whittemore comes into the game. This would be a four receiver formation for UCF.
We're going Wildcat here.
Direct snap to Harvey. And he's got the first down. Is that because they just like what Harvey does, or is that because they don't want to get McClain hurt?
Yeah, I mean, you want to try to take some of the hits off of McClain. Obviously, McClain can do that. But your best runner is R.J. Harvey. And when he gets this ball and gets downhill, you kind of think that he won't get stopped for 2 yards.
So Harvey picks up the first down. And it's McClain again behind center.
Very soft up top. Can spit that out right away to control those linebackers inside.
Play clock's down to 5. They get it off.
There it goes.
Catch is made. Townsend. And Townsend has a first down. He runs well. They love getting him the ball in space.
I love the urgency of Timmy McClain, making sure he gets these guys in that play so they can get that screen thrown out there. You got soft coverage from the back end of Kansas State, and it allows you to catch that ball, get the blocks, and get down the field.
McClain calls his own number, and he has got some Zuzu, doesn't he?
Man, he's got a little shiftiness to him. I said it in the open. He's got a lot of those same skills that John Rhys Plumlee has. Watch him take this ball out. He gets vertical, stick that right foot in the ground. Woo! Excuse me.
All right, I'm going to blow some minds just because he's left-handed. He can scoot. A little bit of Michael Vick there.
I'll take that.
A little bit.
Maybe not quite, but I'll take that.
And now they're going to put McClain out wide, top of your screen. It's going to be a direct snap to Harvey again.
That's a soft edge. He can hand this ball.
Harvey to the 22. Marquise Siegel with the tackle.
So for Kansas State, they're not protecting the edges as much as I would love to see them do, especially on those jet sweep opportunities. They're kind of assuming that Harvey's going to keep the ball there, but they have to respect that you got Richardson coming on that jet sweep at full speed. He can get the edge, and he can really, really scoop.
So the chains will move. It's another first down on this drive. Remember, K-State playing with a true freshman middle linebacker in Austin Romaine.
Soft edge up here.
Romaine number 45 for Kansas State. Right in the middle of that defense.
Behind you.
McClain goes down. Nate Matlack with the sack.
Yeah, Matlack got the sack, but it was Stuffle Bean up here at the top who pushes the pocket and forces McClain to step up, and he just doesn't know where to go with it. He has to make sure that he protects the ball there. That is loose ball security, and it almost comes out. He does a good job of corralling it to make sure, but a nice job of setting up that sack for Matlack.
Matlack and Stuffle Bean combined for a loss of 5. Second down and 15. UCF had to settle for a field goal. First time they had it. Harvey. Nothing there. Kobe Savage coming up from the safety spot.
Yeah, it's a nice job. He just comes down to make the play.
Now Savage and Purnell.
Purnell does a very good job at that linebacker spot. Remember, he's a guy that moved from safety down to linebacker. So the overall team speed of Kansas State on defense is just a lot faster.
McClain's only thrown 2 passes. 13 minutes into our ball game. Third down at 16. McClain's going to have to throw. It's a screen. Oh, it's a beautiful call. Trumped him. First down, and then some. It's a touchdown. R.J. Harvey. What a wonderful play call.
Outstanding.
outstanding play call. These guys are getting to the quarterback. It's a pass down. So what do? They retreat, retreat, retreat. They block terribly and then get out on the screen. Nice job of drawing the defense in by Timmy McClain, dumping it off to Harvey, and Harvey does the rest.
How did Harvey not go out of bounds?
That low center of gravity.
Stout walking the tightrope. Boomer comes on. Something you guess at, other things you just know. Center cut for the best kicker in America. And UCF, they lead for the first time as a Big 12 member. 10-7 is our score. Been there, done that. Gus Malzahn, one of the most respected head coaches in FBS. His team has had the ball twice, a field goal, and now a touchdown. 9 plays, 57 yards. Touchdown catch, R.J. Harvey. That was an impressive drive.
It really was. Nice job for Timmy McClain using his legs, making sure he puts them in position to have those good down and distances, staying on schedule. That's going to be so important here in this game tonight.
Here he comes, Seth Porter. Bad idea. Gets out to the 16-yard line and comes up limping. We've got a timeout. We come back. Kansas State back on offense, trailing for the first time tonight. Yeah, tomorrow it's a huge doubleheader on Fox, starting with Derek Carr and the Saints taking on Jordan Love, who's been a revelation with the Packers, or other regional action. Then in America's Game of the Week, Justin Fields and the Bears going to take on Pat Mahomes and the Chiefs or Cowboys Cardinals, all on Fox and the Fox Sports app.
I think Travis Kelce is expected to be back, partner. He's not going to be on a date with Taylor Swift. He's going to be in the game, baby.
Cleveland Heights High School's own, Travis Kelce.
I don't even know what I was thinking.
Yep. First two possessions for Kansas State. 75-yard touchdown drive. And then Will Howard, an interception at midfield, which gave UCF a short field, and they capitalized with the touchdown. This is Giddens. Giddens has been the only runner that we've seen so far today for K-State. Picks up 2 yards, second down and 8. Now this is big for UCF, trying to see what Big 12 football is like along the lines. I know Gus Malzahn was curious to see how his team would line up with his defensive line against Kansas State's offensive line, and then vice versa, how his offensive line would match up with the defensive line of Kansas State's. There's Phillip Brooks, the veteran, his first catch today, and it's a first down for the Wildcats.
It's a nice job. That's what he loves to do, throw those slant routes, and Phillip Brooks is very reliable in the inside of that defense.
First down throw, Will Swanson, one of the tight ends on the Wildcat roster from Papillion, Nebraska. French for butterfly. Final 40 seconds of our first quarter. Again, Kansas State always quick to the line. And now looking to the sideline, making sure this is what they want to do. Anthony Frias is in the game next to Howard. And they give it to Frias. Nothing there. Jason Johnson, 50-year senior linebacker, makes the stop.
And he's helped out by Walter Yates III. He's doing a very good job of following the guards, knowing where he needs to go, and then going and adding in to finish these hits.
And that will be the final play of our first quarter. So far, so good for the visitors from Orlando. UCF playing their first Big 12 game. They go to the second quarter with a 3-point lead over Kansas State. Welcome back, everyone. Manhattan, Kansas. Kansas State, last year, Big 12 champs. They beat the TCU in the Big 12 championship game. Will Howard, big part of what they've been doing the last couple of years. Devin Gardner, there was some debate as to whether or not he'd be able to play today, but he's gutting it out. He's had his moments in the first quarter. Now we begin our second quarter. DJ Giddens crashes to the ground. Lee Hunter, one of those big 300-pound defensive tackles.
It's
a nice job just staying stout, right? Just a true run stopper. These guys are just hit, extend, and not allowing the offensive line to recreate a new offensive line on the other side of the line of scrimmage. Nice job by the front seven of UCF.
Third down and eight. Howard guns it. Completes. Jaden Jackson. First down, Wildcats.
Nice job by Jaden Jackson. Just makes a beeline from the outside receiver down here at the bottom of your screen all the way across the field. And Will Howard sticks it on him.
Howard wants to throw again. Out of the backfield, Giddens. He's got a running start and a ton of room. Already the first down. Doesn't go out of bounds. Instead, skips to the 24.
It's a nice job. They went four verticals there. They tried to get Ben Sinnott up the seam. He wasn't there. And so what do you do when you're the quarterback? You drop your eyes and you get it to your check down. Nice job of Giddens to check to see if he has to block, but knowing that he has to get out on the pass pattern. Very nice job of checking the ball down, getting downfield.
Ben Sinnott, the tight end, is split wide. And they go deep down the right sideline. And Jackson can't make it. Would have been a highlight level catch.
Oh, that would have been nice. Oh, my goodness. It's the game of inches, Eric. I mean, he stretches out for this one, tries to get it just too far outside his reach. And it looks like he's feeling it, hitting the ground. You know, you hit the ground, expose your stomach. You know, you usually lose the air a little bit. You got to go get a drink of water. He's going to have to get back out there.
Second down and 10. Anthony Freas in the game next to Howard. Little pitch to Freas. Had his face mask gray, wasn't affected by it. Takes it to the 15. And now the helmet comes off late with Josh Seliskar. And he'll have to come out of the game.
Right here, Ben Sinnott hooks him right here. What they're trying to do is run a guy over the top, but he can't get there. Nice job. Getting this ball, getting outside quick, capturing the edge, and getting underneath those offensive linemen that are clearing out the way and pushing guys past the hole.
Josh Seliskar has to lead this game on a third down and two because his helmet came off. And Kansas State, they take advantage. Keegan Johnson.
I love it. I absolutely love it. Great job just moving down inside, right? He started off in a press position against the defensive back. The defensive back is up in his face. You motion him down, and you loosen up that coverage and allow him to get that quick out so you can get a quick completion for a first down.
Just the fifth catch for the transfer from Iowa, Keegan Johnson. First down and goal. Ball's at the 9.
Inside him.
Howard. Batted down. Looks like John Walker, the true freshman defensive tackle from Kissimmee, got his hand on it.
Ruling on the field is an incomplete pass. Second down.
Coaching staff got a chance to talk to them. They were thrilled when John Walker decided to go to UCF. He's the type of Big 12 athlete they need now for this venture for the first time inside the Big 12. Number 40 in white for UCF. Kervins Chokes is getting some playing time. Doesn't play much, but he is needed as one of the defensive tackles right now. Look at Giddens, patient through the hole. Touchdown, Kansas State. Whale of a drive for the Wildcats.
They do a good job of pulling guys this way and getting Giddens right back behind where they left from. So when you see these guys pull, you get behind them, and then he comes underneath. Nice job of Sinnott trapping the defensive end, and you get Giddens essentially walking into the end zone.
So Giddens came into this game without a rushing touchdown through the first 3 weeks. He's got two rushing touchdowns here in the first 18 minutes of our ball game. And K-State back on top by a score of 14-10.
UCF is now wearing number
4. Welcome back to FS1 College Football, sponsored by Hampton by Hilton for the stay. It is a 14-10 K Kansas State lead. There's a DJ playing in Manhattan, folks, and it's not playing at Studio 54. DJ Giddens is playing here at Bill Snyder Family Stadium in Manhattan, Kansas. See where I went?
See where you went.
He's got 66 rushing yards.
Doing a great job.
And then he had taken into account the 28 yards he's got on receptions. He's got 94 total yards. And we're really just kind of getting started. Uh-oh. The dreaded kick out of bounds.
It always puzzles me, man.
Unbelievable. You got a lot of area. You can kick that
it's
ball.
It's a lot of space to kick the ball anywhere else but out of bounds and set up a great opportunity for this UCF offense that, in my opinion, is kind of rolling.
Kicking team. Ball be placed at the 35-yard line. It's first down, UCF.
Extra 10, really, for doing nothing. Chris Tennant going to get his hand slapped a little bit. That's okay. Kansas State rocking on a Saturday night. 14-10. Kansas State has had the ball three times, Devin. Two touchdowns and the interception thrown by Will Howard.
Absolutely. And this UCF offense has done a really good job.
Timmy McClain, second start since John Rhys Plumlee went down in the fourth quarter of their game in Boise, Idaho. Look at that. Xavier Townsend, quicker than a hiccup. Gain of five, tackled by Austin Romaine, the freshman linebacker.
Yeah, I talked about this on the previous drive. The edges for Kansas State are just very tight. I mean, they have these guys inside, so you're able to get on the edge right away. Remember, R.J. Harvey, when he's at the Wildcat position, he always keeps it, and it's so it doesn't affect him as much. But when you have the quarterback in there, he's able to pitch that ball out, and he gets the edge right away.
Blitz picked up. McClain probably should just throw it away. And he does. Under heavy duress.
Eric, I love everything about that play from Timmy McClain. He doesn't leave the pocket prematurely. He climbs into the pocket. He gets into the fight, right? And then he backs out. He sees, then he gets outside. He starts to try to create. He sees it's over, and he throws the ball away knowing that he's outside the pocket to save the yardage and create this third and extremely manageable.
Third down and five.
One of these two guys can get freed up out of this stacked position.
McClain has to retreat. Oh, he just threw it up for grabs, and it is caught. How is that possible? Javon Baker's got it.
They set it up and they wanted to go there initially, right? You're going to get both these guys going on out routes at different levels. He wants to go there, but he just doesn't like it. He retreats, and he throws it up and gives Baker an opportunity. First down, UCF.
R.J. Harvey running with his hair on fire. Nice gain on first down. There's a lot to like with this UCF team. They're unbeaten for a reason.
Yeah, remember I talked about it. The skill set of this quarterback is the same as the previous quarterback, so you don't have to change much about your offense. So this explosive offense is going to stay explosive.
Even when one's left-handed and the other one's right-handed?
You do change where the blind side is, but that's about it.
Yeah, John Rhys Plumlee was off to a great start. We had a chance to see him. But he's out for a while. And so far, so good for McClain. Quick hitter, a dangerous pass. Woo! Will Lee. Dreaming big dreams. Third down and three.
Woo, that was a close one. Will Lee got a beat on that one. He's playing off, but not too far. Not far enough that he won't be able to break on those short hitch routes. But now that you're seeing that he's triggering so fast, you can later on in the game go to a double move to make sure you don't risk that interception.
So, interesting spot on the field. McClain, the quarterback, is lined up top of your screen. So this is going to be a direct snap to R.J. Harvey.
You're going to get this in the soft edge. I would give this ball.
Harvey. Lost it. And Kansas State's got the football. The first mistake for UCF, and it cost them possession of the ball.
Ruling on the field is a fumble recovered by the defense. First down, K-State.
Yeah, you're going to see if that ball is given, he is going to be running currently. But let's see if this ball comes. Oh, that ball clearly out. Nice job by the backside pursuit. That's Parnell reaching in there and punching that ball out. That's a peanut punch if I ever saw one.
Peanut Tillman, love it. Good reference. fumble picked up by V.J. Payne. And now both sides have turned it over. An interception thrown by Kansas State, and now a fumble for UCF.
What a nice job by Purnell, the former safety down at the linebacker position with great speed, running R.J. Harvey down and reaching back and punching that ball out.
D.J. Giddens. Not much there. Taking a look at that line, we saw Ricky Barber early, but haven't seen much of him lately. The two defensive tackles right now for UCF, number 2 Lee Hunter and number 55 John Walker.
Yeah, the coaching staff said that Ricky Barber will be on a pitch count, and it looks like we're seeing much more of number 40, curve and choke.
Howard, remember, he's a little bit gimpy. There's a flag down, and Howard didn't want to take a shot, runs out of bounds. If it holds, that'd be enough for the first down.
It's going to be a hold in the back end. Ben Sennett just running through a guy, and he has to fall down and pull him down to the ground with him. Thing is, you don't really need it because of the gain that you receive from Will Howard scampering down the field.
During the run, holding number 13, defense. 10-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. It's first down.
Did Jordan Mask?
Yep. He's fighting for his life. You got this big guy, Ben Sennett, trying to run down the field, and it's just too much pressure. And so as he's falling down, he just pulls Ben Sennett down to the ground with him.
That is the first penalty against UCF. So they go 20-plus minutes without an infraction, and this is their first game as a Big 12 member on the road. In a hostile environment.
Gus Malzahn is trying to figure out what is he supposed to do, right, with that big guy running through him.
Howard steps up and lofts it over the head of Giddens out of the backfield. Second down at 10.
It's a nice job. If Will Howard is completely healthy, Will Howard holds onto that ball and starts to create. But a gimpy Will Howard has to try to make sure that he gets that ball off so he doesn't sacrifice yardage with a sack. He just didn't know. His clock was sped up. He didn't know how much time he had. I like the decision to throw the ball over the head and live to fight another down.
Last week in the game at Missouri, there was a package of plays for the freshman quarterback Avery Johnson. We haven't seen Johnson get on the field so far in our first half this evening. Giddens. This will bring up third down. Tackle made by Lee Hunter. Walter Yates also in that mix. So it's third down at 6. Some people will call this field goal range. If they don't move another inch, it'll be a 50-plus yard field goal attempt for Chris Tennant.
Got the middle of the defense open. You can get your big guy, Ben Sennett, through the middle.
Quick hitter caught and brought down at the 31-yard line, just at that first down line.
On the field is completed pass short of the line to gain. It's going to be fourth down.
So fourth and super short. And the offense is going to stay on the field for Kansas State.
It's a nice catch, though, by Anthony Freas, who's getting a lot of opportunity because of the absence of Trayshawn Ward. That's a big-time combat catch to even set up this opportunity to go fourth and one. And I think they're going to go quarterback sneak with the big fella, Will Howard, 6'5", 242. The old tush push.
Uh-oh. And there was really crazy. Everyone was bunched up in that line of scrimmage, and a flag comes down immediately. I think that the defense had to be in the neutral zone.
It looks like they were fairly close. Helmets look like they were over the ball. And, you know, they get in that position because they got to try to dig those offensive linemen out if you do go with the quarterback sneak. And sometimes you line up just a little too far.
Offside. Defense. 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Yeah, they didn't pick a number because
it was all of them. Yeah, that's what I was going to say. They didn't pick a number because it's all of these guys. They're all across the ball.
So, That's the second penalty of this drive defensively for UCF. Both penalties have resulted in a first down for Kansas State. Sinnott lined up as a fullback now.
Keegan's got a one-on-one here. They love to try to get him the ball.
Howard can't get it to him. He is brought down. Tremon Morris Brash with the sack. Third sack of the year.
Oh, when they take a look at this, when they go back, they're going to be very sad that they gave up this pressure because Keegan absolutely demolished his defender in his route.
Officially a loss of seven. Second down and 17, all the way back to the 34. Okay, Giddens gets it back and then some. Look at Giddens roll, being pushed inside the 20. They needed 17, they probably got 15, maybe 16.
So they run the ball. It seems weird. Why are they running the ball? Well, you've got these guys back. It's another guy over here. This guy's going to retreat. You got these guys leaving the box. Why not get the ball to your running back that's been so effective here to start this game?
Third down and one. Giddens has the first down. Giddens! Touchdown, Kansas State! This kid can play. Touchdown of the half for DJ Giddens.
I mean, I just love the patience, right? He sees this is a one-on-one. I have the first down, but I want more. And then I want to go one more time, and I want more. Very nice job by Giddens. He is putting on an absolute show here tonight.
That's 212 pounds that moves like mercury.
You just love the poise. When you slow play, I'm one-on-one. I know I got 1 yard, but I want to go get in the end zone. Nice job by Giddens.
We were talking before the game began. Can you believe it? No rushing touchdowns for DJ Giddens. Well, that's a thing of the past. He's got three tutties here in the first half of our ball game. 21-10, K-State. And the band plays on. Kansas State 14 unanswered here in our second quarter. They lead by a score of 21-10. How about DJ Giddens doing his best to Deuce Vaughn impersonation? He had a career-high 128 week one against SEMO, and he may have that before we get to intermission.
Oh, yeah, he's been very impressive, and you can see those three touchdowns are important because he hadn't crossed the line as a rusher, and you get three in the first half. He is having himself quite the night.
DJ not only cutting but creating. So UCF, they'll have the ball again. It'll be a touchback. So here comes Timmy McClain and the Knights offense. Next weekend, all eyes will be on Coach Prime in Colorado for a huge game on Big Noon Saturday. Quarterback Shedeur Sanders leads the Buffaloes against Caleb Williams and the Trojans. It all starts 10 a.m. Eastern with Big Noon kickoff back in Boulder. Then USC Colorado Saturday at noon Eastern on Fox.
You are going to get a highly, highly motivated Colorado Buffalo team. After what happened today, they are not going to be happy. You're going to see guys flying around making plays against USC and Caleb Williams.
From the 25-yard line, McClain. Short gain, Kobe Hudson. I don't think we've done a game all year long where there hasn't been a player with the first name of Kobe.
And Kobe Bryant is an icon.
Kobe Hudson, number two, potentially could be tackled by Kobe Savage, number two, for Kansas State.
That would be cool.
Dancing through the hole, Johnny Richardson. That'll be now third down. Desmond Purnell with the tackle.
I mean, Purnell's quickness at the line of scrimmage, especially against the bigger guys, the bigger tight ends, the bigger tackles. I mean, he just jumps out of the way like a running back with a jump cut and then dives in and makes the tackle.
Third down and five. UCF cannot give the ball right back to Kansas State.
Obvious passing down. Duke is the premier rusher on this defensive line.
McClain wants a bunch. Kobe's got it. Kobe Hudson. Oh no, did he not sustain it? Didn't have it. if it was taken away at the last moment.
Oh, that was almost an outstanding highlight reel type of catch, but a nice job of not.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, continuing the fight through the hands by Keenan Garber. All the way to the ground. You can see his hand inside, raking away, and finally gets that ball out.
This is going to be the first punt of the ball game.
That's textbook for a defensive back. The play's not over until it's over. He can make the catch, but he has to come down with it, and Garber does not allow it.
Mitch McCarthy, low kick, bounces at the 31. Here comes Phillip Brooks, one of the best out there. And Brooks to the 44, a flag is down. Phillip Brooks with four punt return touchdowns.
You're gonna get blocked in the back. You gotta, if you can see his numbers, you have got to let him go. Number 15, Shane Porter, looks like just pushed the guy right in the back.
Holding number 80, receiving team, 10-yard penalty from the end of the kick. First down, timeout.
They get him for a holding. He's looking like, wait, what?
We'll be back in a moment. 4:58 remaining in our second quarter. Will Howard has played every single offensive snap for Kansas State. Touchdown pick, touchdown, touchdown. The interception just made him mad.
It did. It did not make him happy, I can tell you that.
Senior from Downington, Pennsylvania, just west of Philadelphia. We thought we were going to see the true freshman Avery Johnson, but that hadn't been the case so far. Nothing there, middle of the line for DJ Giddens. Big John Walker, true freshman defensive tackle, makes the stop. Yeah, taking a look at that middle of the line, still we do not see Ricky Barber. One of the best that they have.
He didn't line up outside.
Looking for a bunch. Keegan Johnson had a step. Pass was overthrown.
Intended for number 10, Keegan Johnson.
So third down and long. There is a flag down at about the 18-yard line. Kansas State open, hoping that this is something positive. Otherwise, they're staring down the barrel of third and long.
Holding number 54, offense. That penalty's declined. Third down.
Hayden Hadley Panzer.
You see him right there, kind of throw him to the ground.
It's actually a decision.
I didn't like that decision, and I would have taken a penalty.
Second and 19 as opposed to third.
I would have taken second and 19.
Howard, wide open pass too high. Garrett Oakley had a massive gain, and Howard just couldn't put it on him.
Yeah, and he's the guy that they really are happy about. He's getting his first opportunities this game because he was injured in camp, and they saw a lot of potential in him, and he has an opportunity, and he just can't bring it in.
So that's the first three and out forced by the UCF defense. And now the first punt of the day for Kansas State. Jack Bloomer. So the kicker for UCF is Colton Bloomer. The punter for Kansas State is Jack Bloomer. And starting at the 12-yard line and getting out to the 24. And that is where UCF will have the ball. We've got a timeout. Back with more in a moment.
Coming up on the State Farm Halftime, we got Ohio State and Notre Dame in a top 10 showdown. Colorado and Coach Prime's toughest test so far at Oregon, they did not pass. And Oklahoma's defense continues their dominance at Cincinnati. All that and more at the half. Right now, Eric and Devin, back to you.
Thank you, thank you. And we've got exactly 4 minutes until we get to that halftime. It is a 21-10 lead for Kansas State. UCF actually led 10-7 at one point, but in the second quarter they've been blitzed. It's been all Kansas State. After the 69-yard punt, first down and 10, ball for the 24. R.J. Harvey to the edge, and he goes down quickly. Marquise Siegel lays the wood.
Man, look at this collision here.
Oh, my.
Oh, my goodness. And it's nice and safe, right? Both guys get their head out of the way, but Siegel might have gotten the worst of that as he has to go to the sideline.
And I don't know how safe it was for Siegel. He's replaced. V.J. Payne is in, one of the safeties now. Little flea flicker. McClain's got a gun. He's got a man wide open. It's caught. Kobe Hudson. Touchdown. UCF. Man, did Kansas State fall for that one?
Kobe Hudson does an outstanding job of slowly leaking down the field and then bursting. Good night, Irene. All you got to do is make the throw, and it's a touchdown.
Wow. 69 big ones, and that's what the Knights needed.
Absolutely. That quick strike really, really makes things interesting.
Oh, Boomer squeezes it through.
Man, he's such a good kicker, but he makes everything an adventure. The easy stuff, right? Kickoffs, going out of bounds, the extra point just sneaks in the left upright.
Hey, when you're good, you can kind of play with the boundaries, man. He's got to make it interesting for himself.
I suppose so.
He has missed one kick, folks, as a college player, as a sophomore. And that was a 64-yard field goal attempt. The guy's a stud. How about a two-play 76-yard drive, right? That's what you need, huh?
It's not bad. Not bad at all. And remember, one of the safeties, Siegel, he had to come out, right? He has to come out. I don't know if that makes a huge difference, but that's somebody else in the back end with experience. He has to come out for a play, very next play, flea flicker, down the middle for a touchdown.
If you're a play caller, if you happen to be Darren Hinshaw, the offensive coordinator for UCF, can you notice it that quickly? Oh, the safety's out. I'm going to call the flea flicker and see if it works against the new guy in the backfield.
I think you 100% can. I think you can, and I would say that Hinshaw's a veteran play caller, right? And so he sees that maybe, and it could be a call when we get to this yard line, we want to call it. But that can't help when you see a guy in the back end, a veteran like Marquise Siegel, who makes plays. You see him go out of the game. Why not try it now?
And the ball falls off the tee. Welcome to Big 12 football, UCF. There's always wind involved when you're talking about Big 12 football.
I don't think it fits. He's thinking it's not, it's just wiggling all around.
I remember I was talking to Glenn Mason, longtime coach at Kansas years ago, and he said, you're Big 12 head coach, you need yourself a good punter. Wind is always a factor.
Got Hinshaw right there dialing it up, right, getting ready for the next drive as his team kicks off. This Kansas State offense is going to be back on the field.
Returnable. On the return, Keegan Johnson had the face mask grazed, no call, and Johnson out to the 35. Tackle behind by Jason Johnson. A decent starting field position for Kansas State.
Yeah, they're in an argument there because Keegan jumped in front of Brooks and took that one. And Brooks is saying, man, that was for me, man. Would you just, that's going to create a, you know.
0 of the kicking team. 5-yard penalty would be added to the end of the run. First down.
So Jason Johnson was offsides and he made the tackle.
Yeah, of course he was.
Some good and bad.
Yeah.
Is there hierarchy in returning kicks?
I mean, the ball was
center field in baseball. It's always his ball. Unless
no, not always. The ball was going straight to Brooks, though. And so the funny thing about that argument, Brooks is saying that one was for me. And Keegan is saying, he slapped me in my face. It doesn't match. What are you talking about?
Two separate things.
Yeah, two separate things.
All right, K-State went 3-and-out last time they had it. Howard steps up, throws a bullet to his guy, the tight end Ben Sinnott. First down for Kansas State.
He just got such a feel, right? A feel for zone defense. UCF is in zone defense. He gets vertical. He can bend it in, but he just sits nice and big in the zone, and Will Howard goes across the board with his reads, finds him, hits him right in his numbers.
Out some space. This is Brooks.
You don't usually see Brooks miss a read like that, right? You see the guys blocking him outside. He usually cuts underneath that and picks up yards there, but he just gets written out of bounds.
Big week for Phillip Brooks. He celebrated a birthday on Wednesday. He's now 24.
Who else celebrated a birthday?
Oh, we talked to that. Who was it? Was it Colin Klein?
It was Colin Klein, absolutely. Right. Share a birthday, the offensive coordinator.
Kansas State royalty, Colin Klein. Little end around, flea flicker, Howard! Nobody home. That was, I'll tell you what, talk about earning a scholarship. Did Jordan Mask didn't fall for that one bit.
Yeah. He did a very good job of coming out of center field and looking up the big tight end, Ben Sinnott, and making sure he's in position to make that play. And Ben Sinnott was the second read. The rest of the defense did a very nice job of chasing down the guys down the field that Will Howard would have wanted to throw the ball to. That was the second read. Nice job by the safety.
So it's third down so far today. 4 for 6 on third downs.
Jordan Mass has to come out of the game there. He and Ben Sinnott, I think, chalked to the sideline together.
Is caught short of the line to gain by Giddens. So now a decision.
I know he doesn't get the first down there, but that is some kind of catch by a running back. I mean, watch him come. He's going to go the little chase route, right? You chase the guy across the field. Boom. Reaches back and gets hit, and then reaches, tries to get the first down. He puts it close enough that I think they're going to go for it.
That was Ryan Davis, who made a heck of a tackle to keep Giddens away from that first down marker. It's officially fourth down and 2. They need to get to the 41. And whistle stop play. Timeout called by UCF. That's the first timeout in our ballgame.
I think this will be an outstanding juncture in the game to put in the young guy, Avery Johnson, right? Pick up that extra blocker at the quarterback position and allow him to run quarterback power to pick up these 2 yards. I wonder what they're going to go with here, but I think this is a perfect opportunity for Avery Johnson to insert into the game and pick up this first down.
He's 18 years old, hasn't played a snap all day long, and you're going to trust him on fourth down at 2.
Well, so he's done it. He's done it, right? Last week, they put him in a number of different times to just run and go get first downs and to as a kind of like a changeup, and I think they trust him a lot.
He's looking down at the play sheet on his left wrist. 18-year-old true freshman from Wichita, Maize High School. That's M-A-I-Z-E.
He's a good football player. It was so cool talking with the coach staff about his relationship with Will Howard and how Skylar Thompson was to Will Howard what Will Howard is now to Avery Johnson, as far as you have to pay it forward. He's the future. Make sure he's ready to play if anything were to happen to you. And I think Will Howard has done a very good job of that, but they're going to stay with him on 4th and 2. Giddens at the running back.
Howard wants to throw. Designed rollout. And that's going to be short. The catch was made by Jackson. And it's a stop. That's going to be well short of the line to gain. And it's first down UCF. What's that all about, Devin?
The field is the runner was short of the line to gain. The ball goes over on downs. First down UCF.
Well, you got to know Will Howard's hampered, right? So the threat of him sprinting out is not as damaging as it would be usually. And I think you're exactly right, Eric. This is well short. It looks to me like it's well short. They may look at it and try to make sure, because it's such a big part in the game, right? It's a big moment, but it looks like it's short to me.
Now, where it's marked, it's actually like almost a full yard short of where they needed to get. They needed to get to the 41. The ball's actually spotted north of the 42. So the UCF defense, they hold. And now UCF with a chance to score before halftime and really put a scare into the locals.
Yeah, the ball starts to die just a little bit because he had the necessary yardage. But then when he reaches down to grab the ball's in front of the first down line of the game. UCF ball.
All right, we play on. Timmy McClain, second start. Both starts coming against Wildcats. Villanova a week ago. Kansas State tonight. Play clock down to 4. And whistles. They call timeout. Gus Malzahn saved 5 yards.
prior to the snap, Central Florida called their second charge timeout. It's going to be a 30-second timeout.
I'll tell you what, the referee is going to get a talking to.
Yeah, I was
Michael Vanderbilt
that.
Keeps calling him Central Florida.
Yeah.
That's a big no-no. It's UCF.
Yeah.
Yeah, UCF only.
I was like, that was hot.
All right, first three games, a waxing of Kent State. Tons of yards in that ball game. Colton Boomer, player of the week with his kicking in Boise State last week against Villanova, 48-14. That was without John Rhys Plumlee.
Yeah, that was their first game having to go out there without their offensive leader, John Rhys Plumlee. But Timmy McClain in that game subbed in admirably, and tonight he's doing a very good job as well.
Rushing yards, they're averaging almost 300, 299. 101 is really good for a half, but that's well off their pace
of
what they
is.
Had been doing. Wow, 618 yards of total offense averaging. And nothing to sneeze at, 228 in the first half. But
pretty good.
The bar was set so high in the first 3 weeks. First ever Big 12 conference game for UCF. First down and 10. McClain, he's been impressive. Oh, that wasn't impressive. It's picked. Jacob Parrish. The quick change for Kansas State. There's a mistake for McClain. That's a bad idea.
I mean, you're going to see here, there is nobody. I don't know where he's throwing this ball. I guess you can say he's trying to get it to the young tight end, Randy Pittman Jr., but it's nowhere near him, and it just falls right into the arms of Parrish. Nice job of Parrish. Parrish had a rough week a week ago. He was in position to make a lot of plays, and they just didn't happen for him. That's great to see him get an interception in this game tonight.
So now two turnovers for UCF, the interception and a fumble. And Kansas State with a minute 15 to work with in all three timeouts. Howard finds Giddens out of bounds.
UCF is not doing a good job in their zone defense of having eyes on Giddens. That's the second or third time we've seen Giddens a pass protector first and then getting out on the pattern and just being wide open and picking up yardage.
Giddens, 38 yards receiving, 107 yards rushing. Five-man rush across the middle. Giddens, he's got the first down. Clock will stop temporarily. 64 ticks remaining in our first half.
As much as you want to try to replace the production of Deuce Vaughn, I mean, Giddens is doing a very good job, especially tonight. He's lining up at receiver. He's running a shallow cross. He's doing all the things you wanted him to do.
Howard throws a strike. It's Porter. Directly out of bounds at the 34-yard line. First catch on the season for the senior Seth Porter.
Man, it's man-to-man defense, and he just runs right through the defense. It's so hard to cover a guy running across the field in man-to-man coverage. And this is, remember, Porter got hurt on the kickoff return, and he looks like he's fine to me.
51 seconds remaining. Clock is stopped. K-State still with three timeouts. He's been everything for Kansas State. 22 more yards for Giddens.
I mean, this is outstanding what he's able to do because he lined up in the backfield and somehow found his way down the seam to make that catch.
We've seen almost exclusively DJ Giddens. We haven't seen Trayshawn Ward, who's banged up. We didn't expect to see him.
He's going to come here and get in between and go down the seam. That's not something you usually see from a running back, right? You see him post up, maybe do a wheel route, or he goes there and gets up the seam, and the only person to stop him is South Carr. He's not in a position of winning position, South Carr. He's a pass rusher. He's not used to being in coverage trying to stop a guy like Giddens.
It was DeJordan Mask who made the tackle. And may have had the wind knocked out of him, not sure, but he's the one who has to be looked at and leave the game. Number 13 in white. So Mask is out of the game. It's first down and 10. 43 seconds remaining in the half. Clock is moving. Batted away. Woof, there were two defenders blanketing Jaden Jackson.
Jairo Wilson does a nice job. He's eyeing Will Howard the entire time. And for Jairo Wilson, that's a bad play because he saw it coming. You got to make that play, have an interception, whether it gets returned for a touchdown or not. That goes. That's, you know, whatever happens. But you got to try to turn that ball over with Kansas State down here in tight driving.
Howard. Quick hitter caught by Jackson. Clock is going to move. Kansas State's got three timeouts. No real reason not to use it, right?
Yeah, I mean, they got plenty of time, I think, but they are using a bunch of the time that they did have. I mean, my goodness.
And now the timeout is called. Chris Kleiman running down the sideline.
State has called their first charge timeout. It's going to be 30 seconds.
Yeah, I think you...
Game clock operator, please reset the game clock to 17 seconds, please.
You're going
to
give him an extra second.
I think you were right. That timeout should have been called immediately. You got three. Right? It's third and six. You want to get a good play anyway to make sure you pick up this first down. That was a lot of time wasted, but they do still have two timeouts with 17 seconds to go. So if they don't get this first down, obviously they'll call timeout, kick the field goal if they keep the ball in bounds. And if they do get the first down, they still have two timeouts and the clock will be temporarily stopped so they can call a play. They'll probably call two plays in the huddle here so they have the first play run, and then when the clock is stopped, they get that ball snapped immediately after they pick up the first down if they don't score.
And Chris Kleiman knows what he's doing. Four-time national champion calling the shots at North Dakota State. Now in his fifth year in Manhattan. His teams are always just super steady. Maybe not spectacular, but steady. Winning football they play at Kansas State. Send it to man in motion.
Behind you. I'm behind you.
Pump fake. Howard batted down at the line. That was big John Walker, who has been counted on today. They need him, and he has stepped up.
Yeah, that's tough.
I apologize to Matthew Alexander, 56, not 55.
You can see they tried to set something up. He was getting back to the middle, and he had something there. That's a nice job of making a play. If you can't get to the quarterback, get your hands up. Matthew Alexander does an outstanding job.
And one of the first tenets of Big 12 football, you got to have a good kicker. In Kansas State, they do. Chris Tennant comes on. This would be a 26-yard field goal attempt. Ooh, that's ugly. And it hits the upright. No good. And Gus Malzahn is happy. You have a 26-yard field goal attempt for the other team, and they miss it. That is pennies from heaven right there.
Yeah, UCF, they got away with one here because that turnover could have proved disastrous, but it's completely shanked and off the left up post.
Woof. You just count those 26-yarders as automatically made. And when it's not, that's a bonus. So, UCF will come back out with 8 seconds remaining. I can't imagine a world in which they don't just take a knee.
Yeah. Tim McClain has to go make sure he talks to that entire defense and say, hey, man, I appreciate that, right? Because he gave that ball away. He's played really clean to this point in the game. He needs to go back in the locker room, regroup, and get back to the way he was playing football. Not trying to do too much, but playing within the confines of the offense.
Kansas State, they lead 21-17, but UCF will start with a football in the third quarter. Right now, let's send you back to Los Angeles for State Farm Halftime Show.
This is the State Farm Halftime Show inside our L.A. studios. Manuel Acho, Chris Peterson, I am Mike Hill. You see, Central Florida, Kansas State, 21-17 right now, thanks to DJ Gittens, 3 touchdowns. Meanwhile, Texas entered tonight's game at Baylor, ranked third. Their highest poll ranking since 2009 when a young Emmanuel Acho
donned the It always comes back to this
I am
guy.
Still young. I ain't got
Hell, he's still young. That's what I'm saying. As we take a look at our State Farm halftime highlights, you're still young.
Similar breath.
Left behind the ears, still got baby powder on your chest. Quinn Ewers is slightly younger than you, though.
Slightly younger, but he is balling at a much higher level.
Is he faster?
Definitely not. But 30 yards to the crib, he was fast enough on this play. I was proud of Texas, Mike, because this is one of those sleepy games, but you see they're up 28-6 in Waco.
They got OU in 2 weeks. They're leading 28-6 right now. OU at Cincinnati. Cincinnati's first Big 12 game is Dylan Gabriel getting into the end zone, finding Nick Anderson. That was 7-3. And then Gabriel, oh, this is weight room.
Mm-hmm. Get your weight up, son. Mm.
Yeah.
Push, push.
I wanted more. Leg day, making it happen. Oklahoma's defense really coming alive. They get it done 20-6. Meanwhile, after that 3-0 start, Deion Sanders has been a talk of college football. But today, Oregon coach Dan Lanning had plans to end Colorado's feel-good story.
Yikes.
You jump in your helmet, right? Every moment. The Cinderella story is over, man. Right? They're fighting for clicks. We're fighting for wins. There's a difference. Right? There's a difference. Right? This game ain't going to be played in Hollywood. It's going to be played on the grass.
Something tells me he took all that hype surrounding Colorado personally. You think so?
It kind of sounded.
He had some receipts today, though, man, because his team balled out both Knicks, Troy Franklin, Knicks. Once again, a huge – he's a Heisman candidate anyway. Oh, you know, he can do it through the air, on the ground, getting it done. 276 yards, 4 total touchdowns. Oregon rolls 42-6, shut down Shador Sanders in that offense. And, of course, Travis Hunter not able to play for the next couple of weeks, that lacerated liver. And Will Blackman had this to say, Colorado can have Travis Hunter, Hunter Renfro, Bounty Hunter, Torrey Hunter, Lindsey Hunter, Crocodile Hunter. I don't give a damn. Oregon is running that football regardless. And they did it. Here's Deion Sanders. He didn't say that, but I said that. Here's Deion taking responsibility for the loss.
Good old-fashioned butt kicking. No excuses, no nothing. Their coaches did a heck of a job preparing their team. Obviously, we didn't. That was good. I mean, that was a really good old-fashioned butt kicking. We went into the game wanting to dominate several phases. We lost offensively, defensively, as well as special teams. That fake punt kind of got them really rolling, and they didn't stop. It's not just the kids. The coaches are accountable, too. We are all accountable. Let's start with me. We're accountable for this. It's not just the kids. We ain't got time to have no pity party. Ain't nobody walk around the locker room with napkins and tissues. Get your butt up. Let's get on that plane. Let's go.
Oregon had 522 total yards. Buffalo's 199. And it wasn't really even that close, to be quite honest with you, until the second half. Nobody expected this. Everybody expected Colorado maybe to try and keep pace without Travis Hunter, but no one expected this.
I thought Colorado would put up a bigger fight, but as I look at it now they have to stop the bleeding. Coach, you know this better than anybody. You're in conference play now, Colorado. The days of Colorado State, Nebraska, TCU, those days are over. Now you have to stop the bleeding. This game was ugly. Shador Sanders, I believe, Coach, currently has taken the most sacks in all of Power 5 football. So how in the world can they move forward? The last thing I'll say is USC will watch this tape. Mm-hmm. And everything Oregon did right, USC and ASU and every team Colorado has to play going forward, they will try it.
I just hope for Colorado's sake somehow USC doesn't get this tape. Because I don't think they're going to need that tape to help them. Yeah. But, you know, rather than go, like, I think it's so interesting because everybody wants to go right to Colorado. I want to go to Oregon.
Yeah.
This is one of the best teams in the country. You know, this conference is so strong. Talk about SC, Washington, Colorado, this, that. Oregon, I mean, you saw what they have right here. They're so balanced. Ran the ball for 240 yards. Bo Nix, clean. I mean, this is going to be a team to reckon with.
I think that's what Dan Lanning was talking about. It's not just about Colorado. It's about us, too. We've been playing some great football, and we need the type of attention that you've been giving Colorado all season. We hear you loud and clear, Dan Lanning. It's the top 10 matchup we've all been waiting for. Ohio State, Notre Dame battling in South Bend. Highlights coming up next.
Welcome back to the State Farm FS1 College Football Halftime Show. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Fifth straight time, Ohio State, Notre Dame meeting as top 10 teams. No touchdowns into the third quarter. Travion Henderson breaking tackles.
Got to keep edges on defense, Emmanuel.
No doubt about it, man. You got to keep contained. That is rule number one for any defense in football.
Ohio State fans like that. They did not like this, though. Ooh, look who's down. Marvin Harrison Jr. This is the reason why. Rolled up on that ankle, taken off. He was seen walking on the sidelines. We'll see if he's able to get back in this ball game. Moments ago, though, Notre Dame does respond down 10-0. Jabron Payne, direct snap, gets that ball over. Insane, Jabron Payne. We are in a close ball game, 10-7 right now. Buckeyes with the lead in the third quarter. Number 24, Iowa. Number 7, Penn State. Two unbeaten, good defenses. Hey, Drew Allen, Khalil Dinkins.
That ball comes out of Drew Aller's hands, fast and clean.
All Nittany Lions right now, 17-0. Rutgers in Michigan, Jim Harbaugh's back after that 3-game suspension.
Who's got it better than us?
J.J. McCarthy does.
Spotty.
Samaj Morgan 18-yard touchdown. Harbaugh is loving it. Michigan wins it 31-7. UAB, number one Georgia. Carson Beck to Brock.
There he is.
Bowers.
He is.
Brock. Get off me.
We've been doing his highlights
Gosh.
Since 26.
I know. I feel like he's like an 8-year senior. George Rowe, he'll be in the NFL next year. Number 15, Ole Miss. Number 13, Alabama. Yeah, Jalen Milroe, I see you. Okay. Alabama's quarterback issues not as bad today. Jace McClellan finding the end zone. Alabama's defense stepping up once again. They win 24-10. It's the game. Florida State, Clemson. Florida State trying to end a 7-game losing streak. Cade Klubnik, third quarter. Play of the game right here. Kalen DeLoach hits him, recovers. He gone.
What a
he gone.
56-yard scoop and score. That ties the game at 24. Under 2 minutes left. Still tied at 24. Former backup kicker Jonathan White. They just brought him back this week. Lined up for a 29-yard field goal. This to take the lead with less than 2 minutes to go. You kind of knew something was going to go wrong.
You got one job, coach.
In overtime.
Not as easy as it looks.
Well, he didn't have the job last week.
Tied
at 24. Jordan Travis to Keon Coleman.
That Michigan State wishes they had him back.
Oh, doubt.
Florida State up 31-24. And then Cade Klubnik needing this on 4th-and-2. Can't get it good. And Florida State ends their woes 31-24. UCF, they got some weapons. R.J. Harvey's one of them. See if they can get more of this in the second half. They're down by 4.
Welcome back to the State Farm FS1 College Football Halftime Show. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Next week, the Big Noon Kickoff Party heads back to Boulder. Can Dion and Colorado bounce back? Rob Stone, Brady Quinn, Mark Ingram, Matt Lang, Urban Meyer take you right up the kickoff between Caleb Williams and USC taking on Colorado. Coverage begins at 10 a.m. Eastern on Fox. UCLA, Utah, two ranked teams, Pac-12, Dante Moore, first throw he had today. Not a good one.
Hard to be a true freshman and go into Rice-Eccles Stadium and expect a lot of good things.
I know. Won 17 in a row there after today. Moore not having a great day. Sacked 7 times. Utah in that defense wins 14-7. Number 14, Oregon State. Number 21, Washington State. This is all about Cam Ward, y'all. Oh, but look at that catch by Josh Kelly.
It's about Josh Kelly, too. He's got 3 touchdowns on the day already.
Cam's thrown 5. Well, he's accounted for 5 touchdowns. And right now it's 35-21 a game over on Fox. Arkansas, number 12, LSU, KJ Jefferson throwing it up. Loop pass. It's going to be wide open. Yeah, well, somebody busted the coverage.
Yeah, think?
Yeah. We are tied at 24. Now and then, Baton Rouge. DJ Giddens doing it all. He's got 3 touchdowns rushing. He's also leading them receiving. Can they scratch out a win in the second half? Coming up.
Raucous environment, sellout crowd once again. Kansas State, UCF, playing in Manhattan, Kansas. This is the Big 12 opener for both sides. 21-17, Kansas State with the lead. Getting ready for our third quarter with Devin Gardner. I am Eric Collins. We began this broadcast by wondering who would be the quarterback for Kansas State. Remember, Will Howard banged up. We thought maybe we'd see Avery Johnson. Turns out not to matter much with the running of DJ Giddens.
Yeah, absolutely. Coming into this season, Kansas State was trying to figure out who will replace Deuce Vaughn's production. Well, I think they found their guy in the DJ. Giddens is dropping his track on the night, doing an outstanding job. Career highs in touches, receiving yards, and count them. 1, 2, 3 touchdowns. Deuce Vaughn had 3 before, but he never did 4, and it's a whole half to go.
So, some points left on the board for Kansas State. They missed a field goal at the end of the first half, so they're leading statistically in virtually every category. They've had fewer turnovers, yet they only lead by 4. I'm pretty sure that Chris Kleiman would say it probably should be a bigger lead than it is. This is our team comparison sponsored by T-Mobile. It's better over here.
Yeah, remember that turnover for Kansas State, the interception,
turned to immediate points for UCF. And let's not kid ourselves. UCF came to play, and they're playing really good on offense. Timmy McClain had one blunder at the end of the half, but he didn't have to pay for it because Kansas State did not get a chance to put the ball in the end zone. But I'm just telling you, you got a real opportunity if you're UCF getting this ball out of half to take the lead.
Johnny Richardson, look at him go! Richardson to midfield! And a wonderful return to begin our second half by Richardson. Colby McAllister makes the tackle, but it's a massive gain.
And that was extremely well blocked. They did a very good job. I mean, he's not even touched until he's well down the field. Very nice job. I mean, Richardson is super explosive. I remember a quote from John Rice Plumley. He said, when Richardson has the ball, you better get your phones out because something special is going to happen. And you saw some of that special talent right there on that return.
Amen to that. So, wonderful starting field position. Down four. UCF's got it. Timmy McClain, second start, replacing John Rice Plumley. UCF 3-0 on the year, but this their biggest test. Inside run, nothing doing. Maybe a yard for R.J. Harvey. Told you, beginning part of the game, big story defensively for Kansas State. Daniel Green, veteran linebacker, out for the rest of the year with a torn pec. Did it last week against Missouri. Austin Romain, number 45, has been the middle linebacker all game long.
Ooh, Desmond Purnell is a terror for these offensive line. Look at him right there setting the edge.
Richardson cut down. That's Austin Romain. Let us celebrate Romain.
I mean, that's a nice job by Romain, but it's set up by Purnell. Purnell's on the edge and not allowing guys to get outside of him, so it frees up the linebacker, Romain, to come through and make the play.
That's a true freshman linebacker, Austin Romain. Third down at 10. Now, if they can get a decent amount, could be four down territory, or they could try a bomb with the best field goal kicker in the country. McClain into traffic. Caught! Touchdown! Colby Hudson! Who knew? McClain to Hudson for the second time tonight.
What an amazing throw that was by Timmy McClain. Sits in the pocket and just drops a raindrop into the arms of Colby Hudson. Outstanding.
Hudson has three catches. He has gone over 100 yards for the third consecutive week. And the folks in Manhattan absolutely stunned right now. UCF playing their first Big 12 game. They lead by three.
You come in this game, if you're Kansas State and you think you're getting a backup quarterback, and Timmy McClain is making throws like that, completely atoning, in my opinion, for the late interception in the first half.
I'll tell you, if you squint just a little bit, you see some Michael Vick and Timmy McClain.
I mean, he's got some ability. Maybe taking it a bit far. Let's give him a chance here now. Let's give him a chance to make some more plays with his legs, be spectacular, make guys run into each other. But that throw, oh my goodness, that was a thing of beauty.
Three play, 46-yard drive. All set up by the wonderful kickoff return by Richardson. And UCF leads 24-21, and a hush falls over the crowd.
Yeah, you get two big stops on those first two plays, no yardage, even negative yardage. And then on third down, just drops a dime.
Okay, we've got Keegan Johnson, number 10, Phillip Brooks, number 8, back deep. Oof, Boomer's got a leg. Touchback, ball to be taken by Kansas State for the very first time here in our third quarter. Well, we saw nothing but Will Howard in that first half. Remember a week ago in that loss against Missouri, Avery Johnson, they did have a special package of plays for him to use his legs. We've seen none of that so far tonight. DJ Giddens, he's been the workhorse. No Treshawn Ward hasn't played, so it's been Giddens. 14 carries, 107 yards in the first half. Here's his 15th carry, and Giddens, whoa! He's quick to the edge and a stiff arm out across the 40 to the 43. Looking like a bigger Darren Sproles.
I mean, watch him get underneath the rusher. You're going to have rusher coming. He gets right underneath him, and then he gives him a little 1-2 and gets outside. I mean, he's quick, he's big, he's strong, he fights through contact, he gets yards after the contact. I mean, he is an impressive back.
For those wondering, the record for rushing yards in a game at Kansas State, 292. Darren Sproles did it. Gidden maybe thinking big dreams. Look at him go! Shot out of a cannon! Another big rip for Giddens. No flags. And he is close to 150 yards on his day.
Big guys pulling around, leading through. And all he does is just follow Big BB, number 50 in purple. And it takes him down the field.
Giddens now 156 yards. And this time he's going to lose two. Maybe getting a little bit gassed. Lee Hunter just sat on him.
It is what he did, right? He just jumped on his back like, hey, big fella, could you just slow down a bit? It's a nice job getting in the backfield for Lee Hunter. But you have to realize, when you're gashing those giant runs, the offensive linemen are running, right? They're running downfield. They're pulling. And they're getting a little tired, too. So Lee Hunter was able to sneak through and make a play.
Behind the chains now. Second and 12. Little slant, Keegan Johnson to the 20. Second catch for Keegan Johnson. Still has yet to be just a huge part of the offense. First season with Kansas State.
But you can see the flashes, though, right? You can see why they were so excited to get him from Iowa. I mean, as you got Thornton down, grabbing his midsection there.
Thornton had an interception back in the first half.
He did.
There's Keegan Johnson.
And Thornton was the defender that made the tackle on Keegan Johnson on that slant.
Well, with Thornton down, we've got a timeout on the field. Back to Manhattan in a moment. Important drive for Kansas State. Welcome back, everyone. FS1 College Football, sponsored by Hampton by Hilton for this day. Kansas State trailing for the first time since the beginning of the second quarter. 24-21, but they've got the ball and they're marching down the field. Anthony Frias has come into the game. He's spelling DJ Giddens in the backfield. Third down and four. They fake it to Brooks and the quarterback Howard, who's playing injured, he gets the first down. That's called taking one for the team, Will Howard.
Yeah, it's a little odd, though, right? Because you just don't need him to add into the run game, especially the way that DJ Giddens is playing. But I love to see him, you know, continue to fight and battle for his team.
Look at this. DJ Giddens.
Right now, Deuce Vaughn coming for you.
Remember, he was playing in the small shadow of Deuce Vaughn over the last couple of years. But now getting the main job and doing work.
Hey,
4 minutes into our second half. Giddens already with three touchdowns today. DJ Giddens is from Junction City, Kansas, which is about 20 miles southwest of Manhattan. All the males in Junction City, you can call them Junction City boys.
Jason Johnson came from his linebacker position and really put a thud on Giddens in the middle of the hole. That's a nice job by him. Wearing a Captain C on his chest for a reason.
Second down and nine.
There he is in the middle of his defense.
Giddens caught down by his ankles. Lee Hunter again. He has had a real good game. And the officials getting together. There is a flag down.
Illegal formation. More than four players lined up in the backfield. Offense, 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
Got to make sure, and they're probably going to get the tackle here a little far back, is the only person I can see that would be in the backfield and shouldn't be.
That's UCF has changed your mind to decline that penalty. It'll be third down.
Huh? Okay.
Never so heard that before.
Change your mind. Hey, it's Gus Malzahn, man. He gets the benefit of the doubt. Been there, won that. With a win today, Gus Malzahn will have 99 collegiate wins.
Wow, that's impressive.
So it's third down and nine. Third down and nine. Need to get inside the five to about the 3.5, maybe the 3. Sit at the tight end in motion. Howard. Nope, that was blown up from the jump.
Brandon Adams was all over that. And that's a name we just haven't said much. A guy that's an outstanding, lengthy cornerback. We just haven't gotten a chance to call his name a bunch, but he was all over Brooks on that play.
So here comes Chris Tennant. Tennant missed a 26-yarder end of the second quarter. Clanked it off the left upright. Chance to atone. Holder is the punter, Jack Bloomer. Center cut. So we're tied. 24 all. 9:33 remaining, third quarter. When we come back, UCF's going to have the football. Now everything old is new again. A brand new ball game. 24-24. 9:33 remaining in our third quarter. UCF with a touchdown here in our third quarter. And now Kansas State with a field goal, 30-yard field goal. Chris Tennant. Tie the ball game up. UCF playing their first Big 12 game. Off to a perfect 3-0 start. They defeated Kent State, the other KSU. They took down Boise State in Boise, Idaho. And last week defeated the other Wildcats, Villanova. On the return, Xavier Townsend bounced down at the 25-yard line. Chance to make more history. Kobe Hudson, he is already over 100 yards. That is his third consecutive game with over 100 yards. And he's done it on just three catches. Three catches for 119. Good golly. That is the first time since 1999 that a UCF receiver has done that. If you had Charles Lee being the last UCF receiver to do it 24 years ago, I tip my cap. Timmy McClain. Working out of the gun. Play action. McClain. Again, nice pitch and catch. This time it's Townsend.
It's a really nice route by Townsend. Just accelerating at the top and then breaking out on a nice little sail route. And a nice throw by Tim McClain. He's really starting to feel himself here in this game.
McClain keeps it and slips to the ground. He was staring right in the face of Desmond Purnell, and it's second down.
Man, Purnell is an edge-setting son of a gun, man. He is there at the point of attack, making sure that his edge at least is set. They might want to go think about going the other way.
An edge-setting son of a gun. Is that a position?
Man.
And around, this is Townsend. They like to get him in space. Townsend is basically the UCF version of Phillip Brooks. Nothing doing there. He's tackled close to the line of scrimmage. He's going to bring up third down and long. Brendan Mott held his water and made the tackle. Kansas State looking for a stop.
Kobe Hudson right there.
Switch of spots with his tight end, Randy Pittman. Oh, they hand it off to Harvey. Fooled him. Harvey close to the marker. He's going to be just short. It's going to be fourth down and one.
I think you got the momentum. I think you put Harvey in that Wildcat situation, or you can leave the quarterback in. I say go for it here.
And clearly not field goal range, even though you got an absolute stud. They're going to bring in some big bodies. Extra tight end, Zach Marsh-Wojcik comes in. Tight formation.
You got a soft edge to get around here.
Are they really going to snap it? A lot of machinations here. Oh, you got to go into the right center. And they take the delay of game as opposed to calling a timeout, which means they want to punt the football. Well, you kind of knew that McLean wasn't going to get the snap when he lined up behind the right guard.
Delay of game. Offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
You know what I would love to see? The right guard. Get away from me. Get your hands out of there. The wrong guy. But, you know, I'm super surprised they didn't get it for a false start, right? Because, you know, when this quarterback does that head bob really hard, that, you know, if the defense jumps off sides, obviously, whatever, I mean, there would have been no harm, no foul here because they were trying to take the penalty anyway. But I was surprised they didn't throw a flag there.
How about a fake? You take the delay game. You just figure, okay, we're not going to, you know, we're going to punt it away. Perfect opportunity to run a fake here.
I think you might need to be a special teams coordinator. Ah. I retract my previous statement.
Fair catch called for and made. And Kansas State's going to have the football. 24-24 when we come back. 24-24, UCF and K-State. 6:37 remaining in our third quarter. Colin Klein, second year as the offensive coordinator. 2021, he was not the OC. Averaged 27 points per game, 58 plays. Look what they did last year. Improved in both categories. And this year, improving exponentially in both categories.
Steady improvement, man. He was a Kansas State great at the quarterback position. And he's just bled all of that into these players. His pride for Kansas State, I think, is what really helps him as a coordinator. Not to mention, he really knows ball. There he is right there.
If you want a dinner reservation in Manhattan, Kansas, I assume you just call this guy up and you can go wherever you want.
100%.
Table for two, table for six, whenever you want to come. Let's do it. 2012 Heisman finalist, Johnny and Ice Award winner, Colin Klein. Began his career like you did, Devin Gardner, as receiver in college. Giddens. UCF getting wise to that. Sean Peterson makes the tackle. And it's now third down. Kervin's Choate also there, number 40 in white. Choate getting playing time. Just trying to get bodies in there, big bodies in there. Playing Big 12 football for the first time, UCF.
And it's worth mentioning that we just haven't seen the big fellow in the middle, Ricky Barber, the guy that was on a pitch count. He hasn't been in, especially since the end of that first quarter.
Third down at six. Howard steps in, finds the six-year man, Phillip Brooks.
Oh, my gosh.
Phillip Brooks weighs 171 pounds.
Down the field is a completed pass.
What a gutty play there.
I mean, just take a look at this collision on the catch. And I think he might have that first down. If the ball matches where his feet were, I think he has that. He's got that first down by a bunch.
Yeah, they move the sticks. Let's do it. That's a big play by the 24-year-old.
Wow.
And he stays in the game. This is Giddens. DJ Giddens. And he gets that second level. He's got that dead leg. It's really pretty.
Man, he's such an upright runner. I mean, he's so smooth in the way. But then when it's time to lower his pads, he lowers them and makes great contact with defenders. I mean, he is a special kind of athlete.
He is averaging 8.4 yards per carry. Good guy. First down at 10.
Single high safety. They can get to the seam areas.
Another chance, Giddens. Tackle made by Jason Johnson. For Johnson, that's now 10 tackles.
Man, he's everywhere.
I was handed a note before. His first nine tackles were all solo tackles.
Mm-hmm. He's wearing that C on his chest for a reason.
Nameplate's getting a little loose right there. Get off the glue. 4-yard gain for Giddens. Four-man rush. Howard. Nobody home. Looking for Keegan Johnson. Third down at six. Can they convert again? Oh, there's a penalty flag down.
It's interesting to see what this could be. They've had issues with covering guys.
Ineligible player downfield, number 54. Offense, a penalty's declined. Third down.
The tank, Hadley Panzer.
You see him right there. Yeah, he thought it was a screen. He's on a different page than everybody else. He thought it was a screen. He avoided the defender, and that's why that ball had to come out so quickly. I was wondering, they don't usually have leakage that quickly in the offensive line.
That's Jaden Jackson, who is down. Official timeout. Back in a moment. Well, next weekend, all eyes via Coach Prime in Colorado for a huge game on Big Noon Saturday. Quarterback Shedeur Sanders leads the Buffaloes against Caleb Williams and the USC Trojans. It all starts at 10 a.m. Eastern with Big Noon kickoff back in Boulder. Then USC Colorado Saturday noon Eastern on Fox. News to tell you about. Jaden Jackson is heading off to the locker room. We'll let you know if he's able to come back onto the field of play. It's third down and six. And the pass is knocked down at the line of scrimmage. I think that was Josh Seliskar who got a hand on it. And the punt team will have to come on. Oh, there's a flag.
Lay hit on the quarterback.
Personal foul. Uh-oh. Roughing the passer, number three. Defense, 15-yard penalty. First down.
Tremont Morris Brash.
He's going to see him come in and deliver a blow. Yeah, he could have held up. He could have held up. I agree with him.
Oh man, mark that one down.
Just didn't need to touch him, right? You got a punt, right? You did.
Mark that one down. Yeah, Gus Malzahn thought his team was going to have the football.
That's tough. That's a
sharp stick to the eye if you're a UCF fan.
Yeah, but I mean, he shoved him pretty good, right?
I don't think that was
a flop.
So the ball is moved to the 44. Fresh set of downs. Howard. Short gain to Phillip Brooks. Two, maybe three. Brooks celebrating birthday number 24 on Wednesday. Graybeard.
He's a grown up.
Lee Summit, Missouri. Came in with 18 catches. He's got four catches for just 22 yards this evening. Most of the damage has been done by Kansas State on the ground in the form of DJ Giddens. Giddens. A flag comes down. Walter Yates with the tackle.
Right in the middle of that offensive line.
Personal foul. Hands to the face. Number two. Defense. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Falling apart like a $3 lawn chair. That is another big-time penalty against UCF.
Here he is right there. Yep, got his hands right inside the helmet. Of Hadley Panzer.
We've been singing the praises of Lee Hunter all evening long. That's costly. So the ball's going to be moved all the way down to the 25-yard line. First down at 10. 15-yard penalty. Two of them here on this drive against UCF. Giddens. Give him an inch. He'll take a mile. 7 yards on first down. He's closing in on a 200-yard ball game. Things get tight. We're going to go under the 2-minute mark here in our third quarter. Sinnott lined up in the backfield. Hand kind of scoops it in the direction of Sinnott. That was awkward. looking like Dan Quisenberry.
Yeah, he's going to have Ben Sinnott running kind of wide open right here, but he sees him too late and is already falling down and just tries to flip it to him underhanded. Sinnott did a good job of getting through the trash to even get to that place on the field. That was funky.
Third down at four. Kansas State 6-for-11 on third down conversions.
Got to avoid a big mistake here. Don't have to force and get a touchdown here.
Lilping out of the backfield. Giddens gets the first down. And somehow didn't go out of bounds. How is that possible? Like a walking Walenda.
He is good.
I can't believe he didn't get pushed out of bounds.
He is good. I mean, he catches this ball out the backfield. Very nice job. He's done it all day. Caught it on a little swing pass. And then this isn't just tightroping. This is tightroping with someone trying to push you off the tightrope.
Wow. That is some grade A stuff right there. So the ball is going to be moved to the 2-yard line. Giddens already with three rushing touchdowns. Deuce Vaughn never had four rushing touchdowns in a game. Keeper Howard. Touchdown, Kansas State. Wildcats back on top by a score. We didn't even know if Will Howard's going to play today. He's played every single offensive snap and now runs it in for a tough touchdown.
Although that drive was aided by penalties, that's a nice job of Will Howard and this Kansas State offense to drive the ball down and put it in the end zone.
Two 15-yard penalties against the UCF defense aiding the cause.
It's a nice job of Will Howard. He sees Salascar dive inside and takes it right around the edge. If I'm Salascar, though, I commit the same way, right? You've seen Giddens get the ball, and he dives in and kind of almost gambles, right, and gives up the edge. And Will Howard sneaks around the edge.
11 plays, 85 yards, taking 5 minutes and change off the game clock. Big 12 opener for both teams. Second all-time meeting between these two schools. First meeting coming back in 2010. Kansas State won that game. Oh, by the way, the quarterback for Kansas State, Carson Kaufman. Colin Klein was on that team, hadn't won the job yet. Wonderful atmosphere. Really cool environment.
This is not the type of place you want to go down late in the game.
Xavier Townsend to the 25. All right, down by seven. UCF with the football. They were denied last time they had the ball. They got going on, don't they?
They do.
Man, it must be nice being 19. I was 19 once. R.J. Harvey in the backfield with McLean. No, without McLean. R.J. Harvey going to take the direct snap.
Remember, they could get to the edges there.
Okay. And now Harvey wants to throw. High, looking for Johnny Richardson.
I mean, he turned into a real quarterback there. He looked downfield. That was a nice job. It's a nice throwaway because it just wasn't there. He throws the ball over his head. I'm sure he's been coached to do that. But these are the guys on the team that have played quarterback. Look, Nat
left tackle. Tylan Grable, the left tackle, was a quarterback in high school.
A team full of guys that played quarterback, and that's why it looks so natural for Harvey to get in that quarterback posture and then throw the ball away. Nice decision.
Grable 6'7", 280, by the way. High school quarterback?
He's 240.
Quick hitter Townsend going the wrong direction. And now it's third down and long. Austin Moore, veteran linebacker, makes the tackle.
It's the only issue with running those types of plays, right? Because you essentially waste first down if they don't work. You don't get any yards, right? And so then you go to second down and you kind of treat it like first down, try to get that quick screen, you gain nothing. And now you're here with a third and 11. Now we've seen Timmy McClain make plays on this very down and distance, but this is tough sledding against this K-State defense that's feeling motivated.
Third and 11.
Best pass rusher, Duke, at the top of your screen. They better send some help.
Three-person rush. Flag down. It's caught, but will it hold up?
They needed to send help. They held, right? Duke goes from speed to power, and the left tackle just pulls him down to the ground.
Was it the former quarterback, Tillon Grable?
No, I think it was a Mark Height.
Number 71, offense, 10-yard penalty. It's third down.
He never got called for a hold when he was a quarterback.
Yeah, Tylan Grable, he's at the top of your screen right there. He's going speed to power, right? And then he breaks his hands down and then snatches him to the ground. I love the right hand breaking the arm down, but the other hand, you can't pull him to the ground. That's going to be a holding call every day of the week. And before the play started, I said, you got to get help over there because there's nobody on this offensive line that can deal with Khalid Duke, especially when he knows it's an obvious passing down.
Remember, Gus Malzahn's team did not have a penalty in that first quarter. They're starting to rack them up now. Seven penalties for 65 yards. That is a huge difference in this ball game.
It's a big time screen down.
That is the end of the third quarter.
All right, four fingers in the air. We've made it to winning time. It is a one score game. Kansas State trying to go 1-0 in Big 12 play. They lead by seven when we come back. Welcome back to FS1 College Football, sponsored by Hampton, by Hilton, for the stay. We've made it to winning time, the fourth quarter. Kansas State, UCF, seven-point game. Kansas State leading 31-24. This is a third down and long. UCF trying to stay on the field. Good luck. They need to get to the 36-yard line. Delayed handoff. Trying to find lightning in a bottle. Oh, Raptor just got it. Oh, my goodness. Third and 21. How do you convert that?
Wow. I mean, I'm at a loss for words here. This is just screen draw down. You know what you're going to get if you're the defense. I mean, that is unbelievable.
That looked like Darren Sproles to me.
I mean, but I said it, right? John Rice Plumlee, when he gets the ball, get your phone out, push the record button. That was spectacular.
Yeah, the folks in Manhattan, Kansas saying, I've seen that before by Darren Sproles.
Ball, roughing the passer.
Oh, my goodness.
Defense number 31, 15-yard penalty, first down.
And now it's Kansas State that's falling apart. Roughing the passer. Uh-oh. They call it on Jake Clifton.
And he got him good. He tagged him. If you're going to call it on the other side, obviously, you got to call it that one as well. You got to hold up when you see the ball's gone.
So UCF cooking with gas. They've made it across midfield. They're now at the 39-yard line, and this is already field goal range for Colton Boomer if they have to settle. But it's first down and 10. Trent Whittemore comes in, one of the receivers, number 80. They put Townsend in motion. McClain thinking about Townsend, and that ball bounce. That was another low throw plucked up by Townsend, and they're going to say play on.
And he wanted to get that ball out a little quicker.
Yeah, they're going to review.
He kind of slipped.
A completed pass is under further review.
I think I see it better than anyone else in America. Yeah, I call these bounce passes all the time.
I think it's going to be incomplete. I think you're right there. Yeah. But it's because as Timmy McClain turns to try to throw the ball, he slips. And he can't throw it, so he double clutches it, and then he gets his feet underneath him. He throws it kind of late off balance, and that's why it's kind of a bad throw.
So this is the second time today we've seen one of these plays not whistled dead, and I applaud the fact it's not whistled dead.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah, play on. We'll go back and see if it's really a catch or not. Because you can't backtrack if you immediately call it an incompletion and it actually was caught. So I think the officiating crew doing a good job.
Yeah, I think it's incomplete, but yeah, that might not be enough to say 100%. Maybe Dean can help us out and say what he sees.
Well, I'm going to help you get to 100%, Devin. It sounds like you're at like 97. Where are we right now? 98, maybe?
Yeah, let's go 98.
Let's get to me, the ball hit the ground before he had firm control. Gotcha. I think this is a good stop by replay. And again, you got to have control before it touches the ground.
After review, it's an incomplete pass.
There you go.
Second down.
See, that's why we have you here, Dean. I was at 98. Now I'm at 105. I'm good to go.
There you go.
Thank you, Dean. Wonderful stuff. That's the reason why he's called the Dean. Knows what he's doing.
I think it's just his name.
Oh, okay. So it's second down and 10. Ball's at the 39-yard line. Remember, this is a backup quarterback. Timmy McClain.
He's played outstanding tonight.
He replaced John Rhys Plumlee a week ago.
Corner blitz.
Delayed handoff. Look at Richardson. Open field tackle to the nines. Marquise Siegel. Wow, how did he bottle him up?
It's a nice job. Coming from the outside in, shooting the near hip. That's John Rhys Plumlee looking on. Can't help his team right now. It can only be in the ear of Timmy McClain, who's out there playing really, really well.
Third down and 8. Remember, they're already kind of in field goal range, but they're down 7. 13-10 remaining in our ball game and counting.
You got 3 seconds on the clock. Got to get a snap.
Oh, they didn't get it off. Still haven't gotten it off, and now the whistle.
Delay a game. Offense, 5-yard penalty. Down.
Is that a McClain or is that a Gus Malzahn for not calling timeout?
I think Gus is 13 minutes left in this quarter. I don't think he wants to waste those timeouts. I think those 3 timeouts are going to be very vital here at the end of the game. It's going to be a close game. So I think that he saw the clock running down and he made an executive decision to say, we're going to save these timeouts later in the game and go to 3rd and 13.
Game clock operator, please reset the game clock to 1303.
Okay. Remember, these 3rd and long down and distances actually haven't been that bad for UCF. They picked a lot of them up. And those timeouts, I'm telling you, you're going to need them later.
Could be 4 down territory. They don't need 13. Maybe they get 6 or 7 here. Nope, they want a whole bunch. Down the left side!
Pass interference.
Looking for Javon Baker. Jacob Parrish just couldn't hold his water.
Pass interference, number 10. Defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Parrish tried to look back at the last moment, but the damage had already been done.
Yeah, I mean, that's an outstanding job of the quarterback and the wide receiver being on the same page. Watch down at the bottom of your screen here. This play is going to start. He's going to beat him, and watch him throw his hand up. He's like, I'm going. I'm sure he had a different route. He said, I'm going deep. He already had the defender beat, and Parrish just has nothing else better to do than to just get in the face, and hopefully he doesn't call it, but pass interference, free 15.
Now remember, last time Kansas State had the ball, they were helped by 2 15-yard penalties. Now UCF on this drive being helped out by 2 15-yard penalties. McClain, just a ton of time. He can order a pizza. McClain, got to throw it out of bounds, right? Oh my goodness, just a disaster. Went out of bounds, and that's a big-time loss. Why didn't you just throw it out of bounds?
And not only that, you had R.J. Harvey kind of standing right off to your right. Could have flipped it to him, but a 12-yard loss on a... That is tough, because it's not even a holding penalty, right? It's a loss of down as well.
Oh, yeah. It should be 2nd and 10.
Man, he's made such good decisions, but that is one that is inexcusable.
12-yard loss. Design quarterback run, McClain pays the price. Oof. Finished off by Siegel. Clifton, Purnell, and then Siegel on the stop. It's 3rd down.
Man, that is a big, big play. I'm still stuck. I'm stuck at, you know, I love the patience of just sitting around in the pocket and things of that sort. But once you're outside, you have got to let that ball go into the 15th row.
So it's 3rd and 19. They need to get inside the 20 to the 18.
if you're Timmy McClain, you got to take a deep breath and find a way to make a play here for your team.
Blake locked out at two. They're not going to get it off. And they tried to call timeout on the UCF sideline. Are they going to give it to him?
Delay a game. Yeah. Offense, 5-yard penalty.
Oh, my goodness.
Still third down.
This may drop about a field goal range.
And you want to say, hey, get the play in quicker. But on third and 19 with, you know, maybe not the game, not quite on the line right here. But it's hard to find a play for third and 19, right? You've already had so many third down and long opportunities and extra long opportunities. The play sheet is shrinking. And so you're trying to get the play in, and then the time is running out. But this could have been avoided if you just throw the ball away. But all night, Timmy McClain has found a way to make a play, and I'm sure he'll find a way here.
It was first and 10 at the 27. It's now third and 24. Simple handoff. It's worked before. It's not going to work this time. Harvey is smothered. Now, they did get into what would be considered to be Colton Boomer's field goal range.
Of course. That was the plan there. You just want to try to get in field goal range and make sure you have an opportunity to come away with points here.
Colton Boomer, if you didn't know, has missed all of one field goal as a college player. That one field goal he missed was 64 yards last year. Everything inside 64 he's been good for in his college career. Made one earlier today. This one's going to be 53. And Boomer missed it wide right. What a funky drive for UCF. Probably didn't deserve any points. And that'll do it. Kansas State has the ball and the lead when we come back. 10:06 remaining in our ball game. Big 12 opener for both sides. K-State with a 7-point stiff arm on UCF. Raucous environment on Saturday night. Kansas State trying to milk this one right now. Can they get a score and go up by two scores? Anything would work. Brooks, the man in motion. Inside run, Giddens. He's been the story. And Giddens brought down by his shoelaces. The Jordan Mask.
It's a nice job to Jordan Mask coming in. And we've seen all night Giddens getting those one-on-one situations. And the guys just can't make the play. So that's an outstanding open field tackle to get Giddens on the ground.
Giddens is averaging 7.5 yards per carry. Stud. Howard. Slant.
Nope.
Is it knocked down at the line?
Ball was tipped at the line of scrimmage.
Flutter ball.
I mean, that's the worst for a quarterback, right? You got a guy wide open, and you make a throw, you got your technique or whatever, and a guy just flails his arms up in the air to bat the ball down.
We're just talking about short quarterbacks getting their ball knocked down. Howard, 6'5".
Big dude.
There he is. So, third down. Kansas State trying to stay on the field. Howard steps up the pocket. Another tip pass, but it got to Sinnott. Sinnott saved the day. That ball was fluttering in the air, but it had enough Zuzu on it to get to Sinnott.
We talked about her earlier. Ben Sinnott just has a feel for zone defense. They lined up in man-to-man, in a man-to-man look, and then they backed out in the zone, and Ben Sinnott reads it, sits down in the cavity of the zone, and even though the ball is tipped, he's so wide open, he makes the catch.
Four catches, 60 yards for the All-American tight end. Howard. Oh, Sinnott with a drop. Tough catch, but he should have made the catch. All right.
We love Ben Sinnott.
Yeah.
You love Ben Sinnott. That was not a tough catch.
No.
He dropped that.
All right.
Ben Sinnott's got to make that play every day of the week. Right. That's exactly where you want it.
Oh.
Just kind of short-armed it, right? Didn't get his hands all the way around the ball. That's a play that Ben Sinnott's going to make every day of the week. Except for on that one.
Except for Saturday night.
Except for
in the Big 12 opener. DJ Giddens. And Giddens upended at the 45. Landed on his wallet. 8:30 remaining.
I mean, for this UCF offense and defense, for them to have the number of injuries that they have up and down the offensive and defensive line and different things like that, they are playing inspired football, right? They are well, they are definitely in this game, as you know, but the way they are running around and making these plays and bowing their necks when they need to, it's very impressive.
Third down and six. Trips formation, top of the screen.
They're coming zero.
Howard gets it to Brooks, and he's going to be short of the line to gain. They whistle it dead. It's going to be fourth down and a yard.
I don't know, man. It might even be inches to centimeters as Leviston takes a seat right down next to Will Howard. All right, so you see him there, and he reaches out as he's going down. I think that's going to be inches away or half a yard away from the first down.
Well, we got a man down. We'll have a big decision for Kansas State when we come back. Welcome back, everyone. 7:52 remaining in this game. It has become a crucial point in our ball game. We have got Kansas State on the field, leading by seven. Their rushing attack has been really good, but they need to get a yard. It is fourth down and a yard. The offense is on the field. They're going to go for it, apparently. Empty backfield with Howard. He's a big guy. Howard wants to throw. And Sinnott, the tight end, has the first down. That's fitting because it was Sinnott who had dropped that got him into the situation.
Absolutely. When you got a guy like Sinnott where you can line him up in the slot and allow him to work one-on-one and an individual cut and just throw it to him, right? That's one-on-ones at practice and in period number three. Hey, Ben, go line up in the slot and run a quick out route so we can go pick up this first down. Outstanding job and a nice job of Colin Klein knowing his personnel and playing to his personnel knowing that he can win.
Just a field goal would be monumental for Kansas State. They lead by seven. Keeper, Howard, to the edge. And he gets out of bounds at the 20. He didn't look injured to me.
He's got some gamesmanship, man. I mean, this is a guy who he's definitely injured, right? Because we've seen him create in the pocket a lot more in games past. He's not able to have his normal quickness, but as far as straight line, he's taken the ball, and he's done a good job with his legs.
16 yards on the ground and a fresh set of downs. And now they can continue to work on that clock. If they can add on another score and get it to the five-minute mark, Kansas State's going to really like their chances. This is Giddens trudging towards 200 yards on the ground.
This is where you get a chance to lean on that veteran offensive line of guys who have been together, led by Cooper Beebe, and Colin Klein at this point is calling a masterful game. He's leaning into his players. He knows that DJ Giddens has been unstoppable. Will Howard is a mismatch, and he's allowing, Ben Sinnott, and he's allowing Will Howard to distribute.
Christian Duffy is in the game. He has been in for a little bit, playing one of the guard spots. He's making a difference. It was Duffy who opened up that hole. Duffy, number 73, hadn't played the first 3 weeks, but we knew he was going to play today, only in special moments.
Yeah, he does a good job of just clearing down that defensive line and allowing the pulls to come around and get through.
Yeah, the coach is just ecstatic getting Duffy back and using him only right now when they need to keep the running game on the field and work on that clock. Giddens, 195 yards. 5 yards away from Nirvana. Diddy, at maybe 200 right on the nose. The last time a Kansas State player had 200 yards rushing, 2018, Alex Barnes had 250.
Good God.
All right, officially now Giddens. That was an 8-yard run, so he went over 200.
The impressive thing with Giddens is he's got the same bounce and pop that he had when the game first started, right? He doesn't look like he's tired at all. Okay. He's carried the ball quite a bit.
It's a 5-yard gain, so 200. Inside run, this is Brooks. You're choosing to run a guy who's 171 pounds off the edge.
How about Giddens getting on the edge and making a nice block, though, there?
So third down, we're at the 4:30 mark of the fourth quarter. This has been a great drive for Kansas State just in terms of whittling off time off the game clock. You figure K-State's not going to be in any hurry. They got 20 seconds to call this play.
I'd love to see them race to the edge down here at the bottom of the screen.
Ooh, Howard left some meat on the bone. Little option. Giddens! Touchdown! His fourth touchdown of the game.
When you run that speed option, the guy who has to get the pitch man is usually inside here, right? If he's inside there, he can't get outside. He has to try to fight through the trash. There is nobody for the pitch man. A great call by offensive coordinator Colin Klein and perfect execution by Will Howard and DJ Giddens.
And how about the gutty effort of Christian Duffy? Hadn't played all season long. They call on him. Oh, my goodness. What was that? Chris Tennant, that was another bad shank. Missed a 26-yard field goal, and that one, well, may not cost him. Kansas State, they lead by 13. Now the folks on Manhattan just giddy about DJ Giddens. He's our good hands playmaker, sponsored by Allstate. You're in good hands.
He's been outstanding. I mean, just doing everything that was needed today, and they needed every bit of this.
Goodness.
Yeah, I mean, they don't have control of this game without the dominance of DJ Giddens. I mean, he was special all night, and the night continues.
It's an old-school Big 12 game on the ground. 29 rushing attempts for 202 yards.
The rest of the team,
28 touches total.
That's everything.
That's crazy. That's not even including his pass catching.
So, yeah, Kansas State has run 80 plays. Giddens, 29 rushes, 8 catches. He's actually targeted once. So that is, my goodness, the lion's share of the offense. One guy. 37 touches out of the 80 plays.
We knew he was good, but my goodness, man. He really showed the load. Remember coming into this game, we knew he would get more of the load because Treshawn Ward is obviously out. Will Howard a little banged up, and they didn't even have to use their Avery Johnson young quarterback package because Giddens was just so dominant all night.
Just a real disparity in plays run. Inside screen, this is Kobe Hudson.
Hudson's.
Is the 44th play run by UCF. 80 plays have been run by Kansas State.
Kobe Hudson is having himself quite the day as well.
Third consecutive week he's gone over the century mark in receiving yards. McLean batted away. Nice defense played by the corner, Parrish. Well, UCF playing their first Big 12 game. Came into this one perfect, 3-0. Wins over Kent State at Boise State. And last week against Villanova. McLean goes down! There is a flag. Brandon Mott with the sack.
I'm going to get a hold. Big 78.
Holding number 78. Offense. A penalty is declined. Third down.
That's something that needs to be discussed, Devin. There's been a ton of penalties, particularly in the second half, for UCF.
Yeah, and I don't love this one. I think that he just finishes them, right? He continues to move his feet, and I think that Duke is trying to fight to go make the play, but I think that Kite is doing a very good job of running him down. I don't love that holding call.
So it's third down at 20. This is going to be four down territory. McLean. McLean keeping the play alive. And this time he throws it away. And I know there's a lot of fans down there in Orlando saying, why'd you do this last time we had it? And there's a flag down.
It's a lay hit on the quarterback, and it might add targeting to it as well. He hit him nice and high with his helmet. Didn't duck his head, I don't think. But I think he made helmet-to-helmet contact up top with a defenseless player. Ball is completely gone. hits him up top.
I don't know about that.
That's head or neck area.
There's no foul for an eligible player downfield. The quarterback legally ground the ball. Fourth down.
Wow.
All right, so that's tough because he definitely hit him up top, and the ball is clearly gone.
So Kyle Clifton, or Jake Clifton, breathing a sigh of relief.
Yeah, that's what Gus telling. That's what Gus Malzahn was talking about. The ball is clearly gone. At the least, roughing the passer.
It's tough. Now this is the ball game. Fourth and 20. Oh, good luck. McClain gets 10 of the needed 20. Austin Moore makes the tackle, and Kansas State's going to get the ball back.
I mean, and you, I've been there where it's fourth and 20, and you take off running. You're like, oh, my goodness, there's no way I'm going to get it. Kansas State is going to start this one away when we come back.
They're getting wild in Manhattan. It's a DJ-inspired party. DJ Giddens has been dominant. Just 3 second-half possessions for Kansas State. That's incredible, right? Yeah, look at how long these drives have been.
When they showed us the graphic, you didn't believe it. You're like, wait, what? No way. And then there were 7 offensive drives for Kansas State in the first half. That's a big disparity, but they've been good, and it's because of DJ Giddens.
Giddens has already gone over 200 yards on the ground.
Just can't take a loss.
And people already starting to whisper about him as the Big 12 Offensive Player of the Week.
I've heard the whispers.
4 touchdowns for Giddens. Now, no job share. He came into this game actually 1 fewer carry on the season than Trayshawn Ward. Ward had 37 carries in 3 games. Giddens had 36. Giddens didn't have a touchdown coming into this game. He's got 4 of them now.
He's got 4. And I'm just telling you, they're trying to look for the guy to replace the production of Deuce Vaughn. Deuce Vaughn never had 4 in a game.
And now the senior quarterback, Will Howard, taking a lot of time off. And he's going to stay in bounds. Oh, he's not going to go for the lead. He's going to get a touchdown. He got greedy. Will Howard, his second rushing touchdown.
I mean, he's had this all night, just getting a chance to take the ball out and get on the edge. And this time, he hits his head on the goalpost.
I don't know, Eric. I might be with you, man. I don't look like a guy that's hurt.
No, but
when you're winning and everything's going good, you feel a little better.
All right, I will ask you this, Devin. You played the game at the highest level 5 years at Michigan.
Uh-huh.
That first play by Kansas State, running play, clock was moving. Gus Malzahn did not call the timeout. It looked as if UCF was not going to call any more timeouts, and maybe they were just going to let this thing play out. Is Will Howard, is that okay form for him to run it in for a touchdown?
What? Yeah, what do you mean? If I'm not getting tackled, you better keep running. Okay. What do you want him to do, just go down? Absolutely not.
I thought that maybe UCF was saying, hey, okay, let's just get out
and
of
Gus Malzahn doesn't expect him to. Absolutely okay. Not.
Maybe not the only person in the world who thought that.
You go hit your head on that goalpost and nobody's going to stop you? What? I can see, you know, like we had a games together where people kind of do a flea flickers, you know. You know, they don't want to call a flea flicker, but you're just running a 200 meter dash around the edge. You don't go down.
Okay, all right.
You go down before you go out of bounds, obviously. But yeah.
I wanted to make sure.
Welcome to the Big 12, says Will Howard. But I think Gus Malzahn was trying to wait and see. I think they got too many yards on that play for him to use the timeouts. Okay. I think that's why he didn't call it. And I'm sure he didn't anticipate a long touchdown by Will Howard on the next play. But when he got that many yards, it's almost like, okay, see if they get the first down and then start the timeout. See if we get a much better stop on the next set of downs.
Really interesting day for Kansas State fans when you think about it. Ball goes to the end zone. That'll be a touchback. The all-new Undisputed is here. Skip Bayless is back, joined by NFL legends Richard Sherman, Michael Irvin, and Keyshawn Johnson. Undisputed weekdays at 9:30 a.m. Eastern only on FS1. There's a lot of people associated with Kansas State, big-time fans that are looking forward to seeing just a little bit of Avery Johnson. He's kind of caught the imagination of the Kansas State fan base. We came on the air thinking maybe it'd be a job share. Maybe Avery Johnson would.
I'm just telling you, Will Howard took a sensu bean. He said, you know, Senzu, you don't know Dragon Ball Z. Dragon Ball Z, Goku, they have Senzu beans that make you feel 100% better no matter how hurt you are. And he said, I am not allowing the world to see this young guy just yet.
Crossing route and heading out of bounds is the true freshman tight end, Randy Pittman.
Jeez, all the way to the benches there.
So the clock stops, 1:53 remaining.
Eric, you should watch an episode or two of Dragon Ball Z, see what those Senzu beans are all about.
Gotta write that one down for me.
Senzu bean, man.
Okay. That's the first catch for Pittman.
No matter how hurt you are, completely heals you.
Some kind of balm or something like that?
No. It's just a bean. Like a little bean.
All right. Three-man rush. McLean. Oh, my goodness. That was spiked away by Keenan Garber.
I'm going to call him for pass interference there. I think he did make contact as he was attacking the ball. He made contact with Townsend there, who's still down on the ground. He comes off of his. Yeah, he's early. Oh, yeah. Man, elbow to the back of the head. Jeez.
All right, a question about UCF. From what you've seen, and this is now the third game you've seen with UCF.
Pass interference, number one. Defense. That'll be a spot automatic first down.
We always talk about when Power 5 teams play FCS schools or they play two teams that are not in Power 5, that sometimes the depth, sometimes the strength, it just doesn't match up. UCF, this is now their first year as a Big 12 Power 5 school. How close are they to having the strength, the power, the
depth? They're there. They're 100% there. Remember, this game was a one-touchdown game, and UCF was driving until McLean took that large sack, and they weren't able to get points on that drive, and then it started to snowball. This game, it looks a lot worse than what it really is. UCF is a force in the Big 12 right now.
Woo!
Absolutely. This game is against the defending champ, and we think fairly highly
There's
of
no
K-State.
There's no problem for intentional grounding. Number 13 was in the area.
We think fairly highly of K-State, and they were completely in this game. Obviously, you got the long Will Howard touchdown that we just saw, and then the touchdown drive after the mistake by McLean to not throw the ball away. This is a lot closer game than it seems on the scoreboard.
So 1:39 remaining in our game. It's second down and 10.
And Eric, we can't forget to mention a super banged up UCF team, right? They don't have their quarterback. Their top defensive lineman, Ricky Barber, who would have made a world of difference with Giddens, exactly, right? And so you have that guy out. You've got your quarterback out. I mean, it's a lot. No, obviously, no excuses. They played a great game, and K-State played an outstanding game, and especially Giddens. But this UCF team is a force to be reckoned with for sure.
McLean showing nifty feet. He'll find the sideline. This is what K-State is just trying to do. Make UCF take a lot of time off the clock.
And this K-State team is in rare form, huh? Just like UCF, this is a Will Howard who, you know, he had a Senzu bean, of course, but he's not 100% healthy, and he was able to do whatever he wants in the passing game. They got Ben Sennett. I mean, this team's good.
McLean wants to run it again. And he faked like he was going to go out of bounds and then continued to run right in front of the Kansas State bench. They didn't like that. But he's got enough for the first down.
They kind of went for like a little stiff arm there on Cody. He's like, wait, man, I'm just trying to climb up. I'm not going to hit you.
Well, UCF, they'll have a chance to get their first Big 12 win next week. They're home. They're going to take on Dave Aranda's Baylor Bears. Oh, McLean's got a bad habit of running backwards. And the lefty going right, not able to throw the football, stumbles out of bounds. He is gassed. He is going to sleep well tonight.
He fought admirably. It's just the one glaring mistake that he's going to look at. And it wasn't even a turnover, right? But it was a huge sack when they were in position to go down and put points on the board. They were rolling. They got some help.
17.
They got some help with some penalties, and he had the opportunity to throw the ball away. And he's going to look back at that because he's a veteran guy, right? He's had opportunities to start at USF, and he's going to be sick about that decision to just run out of bounds there.
So now just a run to Harvey, and the clock moves. UCF's got three timeouts, and Gus Malzahn, I don't know if he's going to use them. I think he just wants to stay as healthy as possible and get ready for Baylor next week.
Absolutely.
And three flags are on the field.
Illegal snap, number 52, offense, 5-yard penalty, third down. UCF has called a charge timeout to avoid a 10-second subtraction. First charge, 30 seconds in duration.
Hey, did you hear the chant from the crowd?
Bring on the Cowboys.
Warm up the bus. Bring on the Cowboys. They play Oklahoma State.
That's 2 weeks, though.
Week.
No, it's 2 weeks.
Oh, 2 weeks. Oh, yeah, of course.
Man, you're going to hold your water a little bit.
I know, right? They got a bye week.
Yeah.
They're still singing it. That bus is going to be warming for a long time. You got a week off.
They can walk from Stillwater. I mean, you need a bus if you're going to give 2 weeks.
I was really impressed with Kansas State today as well, though. I mean, they had a lot of opportunities in, on third down and four-minute offense and putting together two-minute offensive drives. I mean, they really showed that they are coming into form here as you get deeper into the season, and there's their schedule upcoming, obviously a bye week, and then warm up the bus and bring on the Cowboys at Oklahoma State, at Texas Tech. It's not going to be easy. And then versus TCU, who we saw earlier today.
Third and 15. Oh my goodness. Send in the house. Under pressure, fourth and 15. All right, so this may be our last competitive play of the day. Fourth and 15. If they don't get it, Kansas State will come on and take a knee. Kansas State a week ago lost on a last second bomb of a field goal at Missouri. McLean. And that's caught. Harvey got the first down. And down to the 1 yard line. Clock will stop temporarily. Clock stops 17 seconds. And UCF trying to put another touchdown to the board. Did he? No, he's short. He's short, and the game's gonna end. Oh, UCF called a timeout. UCF just called a timeout.
Central Florida called a timeout. Second charge, 30 seconds in length. Game clock operator, please reset the game clock to 6 seconds, please.
Justin Wilson's gonna have Michael Vanderveld on speed dial. We're UCF, partner. We're UCF, not Central Florida.
Oh, man. The crowd is letting them have it. It just doesn't matter. It does matter. UCF has a schedule coming up. I mean, I like the showing that they had today in their inaugural Big 12 game. Baylor next week. At Kansas is not going to be easy. At Oklahoma, who's playing really good football.
After a bye, though.
Yep.
And that's going to be the first loss of the year for UCF. So both sides are going to be 3-1. The difference is going to be UCF's 0-1 in Big 12, while Kansas State's going to move to 1-0 in Big 12 play. Now, 6 seconds remaining in the game. Gonna be a direct snap to Harvey. Harvey, that's a touchdown. So there is your touchdown. A little bit of window dressing for UCF. Something to feel good about on the way back to Orlando. And they're gonna go for one. Get Boomer in a good spot again after missing his first field goal in a year.
When they go home and look at this film, though, they're going to see that there are some opportunities out there. And you were in a dogfight with the reigning Big 12 champ, defending Big 12 champ. And if a few different things go differently, this game may go into overtime. That's what it looked like it was heading toward. So, I mean, I think they have a lot to like about this film that they're going to watch. And, you know, a lot of things that they have to clean up before they head to Baylor.
I wonder if Colton Boomer ever thought about going to Oklahoma. Whenever they sing the song, he could thought about it. It's for him. Boomer, Boomer Sooner. That song?
I do not.
Okay.
I don't know the song.
We want it. What's the University of Michigan?
They play it after every touchdown at Oklahoma.
I've never been to Oklahoma again.
All right. All right, so we're going to have to kick this thing off, and then it'll be All She Wrote. Unless something absolutely bizarre happens, it's going to be a 44-31 final. And Gus Malzahn will look for the first Big 12 win in UCF history next week at home against Baylor. Congratulations, Chris Kleiman and Kansas State. They pick up the win to move to 1-0 in conference play. NFL doubleheader tomorrow. You get the Saints, Packers, Bears, Chiefs. Coverage beginning 11 a.m. Eastern time. Devin Gardner, was a blast working with you, partner.
It's always fun.
So congratulations, Kansas State 44, UCF 31. It's in the books. For my partner, Devin Gardner, I'm Eric Collins. Good night, everybody, from Manhattan.